2022. Welcome po sa ito yung mga bisita sa ito yung Bible study for this month of July. Ang title po, ito yung Bible study, kita po sa ito yung screen, where are we now in Bible prophecy. Ito po na palago yung mga reliyon, mga sectary reliyon ang nagsasabi kung ano ba nang talaga ang propesya sa Biblia. Sino yung iba ay nag-aaral? Hindi mga tugang na aga. Adalata ang nasa bit ng mga propesya base po sa sabi ng Biblia. Ako sa sabi ko ng isang mga tao. So, mga tugang, ipipresenta rin po sa inyo ang sabi ng bisita si Mr. Lego Cruz. Bago po kaya, ang opening kayo ng damo, tayo na po. Tulong ko po kita. Amang manalang, Diyos na mga kapan, sa hindi mo nilangin sa kasindaga. Diyos ni Abraham, ni Isaac, sa Israel, nadulog po sa iyo mo, nilangan ng Sabat, para maagatan sa iyo ang mga misyon sa Samuya, as in, sa iyo mong inspirasyon, ikaw po sa Samuya, ang mga espiritu sa pag-ibigti, ang mga kapurami na pagkakasakabago po sa mga ito po ay masagutan niyo, mabuksan sa mga bisi, kasi puso. May tindihan niyo, lalo po sa tao, para po sa ama sa kapanuan, at sa iyo, lalo sa pagbo, at sa iyo mga halin. Ang lakos mong inyama, inahalag niya, sa iyo, pagkasalanan po sa iyo, sa panagang pangalan sa mga atin, sa Yesu Cristo, at sa mga kaburangan, sa mga paratubo, sa mga matagdugan, sa mga halin, sa mga pagkakasalanan sa iyo, mga halin. The glory, honor, might, and power are yours, almighty, glory. And your will be that in every scenario, forever and ever. Turun po kita mga tuso. Itawa ko na po sa inyo ang saluyan ng speaker, our visiting minister from Manila, Mr. Lego Cruz.
Good morning po. Good morning everyone. It's good to be back. So today, we will begin our study with Bible prophecy. Today, we will talk about Bible prophecy. Ang objective po natin ay para lalo nating malinawan kung ano ba ang tinatawag sa Bible at kung ano ang dapat natin maintindihan tungkol sa tinatawag na prophecy. Now, prophecy is interesting and we are told that those who truly understand it, they are blessed. Basahin po natin sa Revelation chapter 1, beginning in verse 1. Si John, we are told, the revelation from Jesus Christ, which God gave him to show his servants what must soon take place. He made it known by sending his angel to his servant John, who testifies to everything he saw, that is the word of God, and the testimony of Jesus Christ. Blessed is the one who reads aloud the words of this prophecy, and blessed are those who hear it and take to heart what is written in it, because the time is near. So dito sinasabi sa atin, it is the person who actually listens and places it in his heart, yung mga prophecies na iyan, that is blessed. And we are told the time is near. Now, Bible prophecy is one of the greatest proof that God really exists. And not only that, that God's words are true and reliable. Now, as Christians, our understanding and interpretation of Bible prophecy, dapat it is accurate as it is possible. See, Jesus, while he was still here on earth, he told us to watch world events and to pray always so that when these events begin to happen, especially in tribulation, we can escape. Let's read that on sa Luke chapter 21 and in verse 36. Sabi ni Jesus, be always on the watch. In other words, we should be watching yung mga events na nangyayari sa paligid natin. And when you are reading prophecy in the Bible, ang focal point mo palagi yan, ang center ng prophecy is always Jerusalem. So, in other words, kapag sinabi nilang watchword events, ang primary focus mo is in fact Jerusalem. Pray, sabi niya, that you may be able to escape all that is about to happen, that you may be able to stand before the Son of Man. Now, in recent world events, marami sa mga tao dito sa mundo, they are already thinking of prophecy because marami naman sa mga Kristiyano, nagbabasa din naman ng Bible. They are aware that things are going to go bad. And whenever things go bad, they are always reminded and ask themselves, ito na ba yun? For example, yung nangyari noong 2008, the financial crisis ng US. Now, bakit tinitingnan yung US? Because we generally believe that the US is one of the original tribes of Israel. Ang designation niyan is isa siya doon sa mga anak ni Joseph, particularly Manasseh. Britain, we understand to be the other brother of Manasseh, which is Ephraim. Yan. Para yung mga anak ni Joseph yan. One of the sons of Israel noong araw. Kaya, when US began to have a crisis, especially financial, because it is one of the prophecies in the Bible, everybody is asking, eto na ba yan? And also, yung September 11 attack doon sa towers. And yung rise ng ISIS. Kung hindi mo alam yung ISIS, that is the Islamic State of Iraq ba yan? Iraq and Syria. Oh yan, Iraq and Syria. And pangalawa, pangapat yung Brexit or yung exit ng Britain sa European community. Because we understand that Britain is Ephraim, and they are not supposed to be part of the European community. They are supposed to be separate. And of course, maraming mga events like global warming, yung mga crisis in Africa, yung escalation ng Middle East conflicts. In fact, pati yung pagkaka-elect ni President Donald Trump, everybody was thinking, naku, ito na yan. Magkakaloko-loko na tayo because si Donald Trump na ang presidente ng US. One of the things we need to understand about world leaders, especially when related to Israelite nations, is that ang Diyos kasi meron siyang prophecy. He is the one who establishes leaders. He is the one who puts them in office, and He is the one who brings them down. That is specific sa prophecy. That is why even si Paul in his letter to the Romans, ang sabi niya ay, you respect and even pray for world leaders because they are also God ordained. It does not matter kahit mabuti siya or masama siyang leader. God allowed them to be in office because siya talaga ang nagtatalaga niya. Now, most of these leaders, they do not understand that. They think that they came to power on their own. Now, one such leader in the early days think that he came to power on his own, si King Nebuchadnezzar ng Babylon. And God had to do something and show him that it is not by his own power that he came to office for 7 years. God brought him down and made him act like he is a beast or an animal until he recognizes that God is the one who put him in charge. And even today, because God is overseeing the general events in prophecy, yung mga world leaders na yan, including our own president, si President Duterte, lahat yan sila, they are God ordained, whether we like how they rule or not. But God allows them in office. If God does not like them anymore, God is going to do something and remove them from office. But for as long as they are there, you can be assured that God wants them to stay there. And of course, yung recognition recently ng US that Jerusalem is now the capital of Israel. Now, significant iyan because Jerusalem, as I mentioned earlier, has always been the center of prophecy. Maliban pa dyan, if you are not aware, there are also brothers. Judah, or yung tinatawag natin ngayon na Israel, which is actually the tribe of Judah, and the U.S. itself, magkapatid din naman yan. They are brothers by Israel. Si Joseph at saka si Judah, they are brothers. And of course, yung recent, yung events, yung North Korea Summit. And marami pa yan. Ito mga trade wars na nangyayari between the U.S. and China and all other things. We generally believe that the fall of the U.S. and Britain will essentially be due to a financial crisis. And today, we will attempt to do three things. Medyo mahaba-haba ito. So medyo, pag kami nagugutom kayo, may kape dyan, magkape na kayo habang ikikinig. Because this is going to be long. This is longer than our usual Bible studies in the past. Marami tayong i-discuss na events, especially the book of Revelation. Three things. One, we will try to understand the timing difference between yung tinatawag sa Bible na last days at yung tinatawag din sa Bible na the day of the Lord. Pangalawa, we will try to understand the timeline of prophetic events. And pangatlo, we will try to identify dito sa timeline na ito, nasaan na tayo? Where are we now in prophecy? So first, let us discuss ano yung tinatawag na last days and day of the Lord. The Bible talks about the last days and the day of the Lord. So the question is, yung bang tinatawag na last days, is it synonymous with the day of the Lord? The key to understanding this prophetic timeline is to understand ano ang pinagkaiba ng dalawa. Most churches believe that the last days is synonymous with the day of the Lord, that they are one and the same. At ito po ay maling paniniwala. We will try to show to you in a little while kung bakit. When talking of the last days, many erroneously think that about a momentous event when all these things happen in an instance or yung mabilis ang pagkakasunod-sunod. Short and quick. When people read about Isaiah chapter 2 and Joel chapter 2, for example, the conclusion is yung tinatawag na last days lies in the future, hindi pa sa pangayon, sa darating panapanahon, towards the end of the age, the unveiling of the great tribulation followed by the immediate return of Jesus Christ. So basahin po natin yung sinasabi sa Isaiah and mamaya rin sa Joel. Isaiah chapter 2 and in verse 2. Sabi ni Prophet Isaiah, in the last days, the mountain of the Lord's temple will be established. As the highest of the mountains, it will be exalted above the hills and all nations will stream to it. Now, one of the things you need to understand about prophecy is that yung mountains, usually, refers to yung mga malalaking bansa, big nations. And yung hills, refer to small nations. Yan isa sa mga Bible symbolisms. You need to understand that para maintindihan niyo yung ano ang sinasabi sa scripture. For example, pag sinasabing tao or people, it is usually referred to as waters. Kaya kung mapapansin niyo yung sinasabi yan, all nations will stream to it. The people are like water that will go to the mountain of the Lord. Ayan yan, yung mga symbolism. So, pag sinasabing waters, especially when it refers to prophecy, it refers to nations, people. Or, pag sinabing mountains, malalaking bansa. Pag sinabing hills, maliliit na bansa. Ayan. And let's go to Joel chapter 2. Beginning in verse 28. Sabi ni Joel, speaking in vision, afterward, I will pour out my spirit on all people. Your sons and daughters will prophesy. Now, take note, hindi lamang sons yan ha, ang nakalagay dyan kasama ang daughters. So, when you hear of a person prophesying, regardless of whether babae yan or lalaki, you have to listen. Most people in olden times, kapag babae ang nagsasalita, they tend to not listen and reject. But that is not what scripture is saying. Sons and daughters yan, pareho. They will receive God's Spirit and they will deliver a message. Sabi niya, your old men will bring dreams, your young men will see visions. Continue in verse 29. Even on my servants, both men and women. See, inulit yan. Ganyan na naman. I will pour out my spirit in those days. I will show wonders in the heavens and on the earth. Blood and fire and billows of smoke. The sun will be turned to darkness and the moon to blood before the coming of the great and dreadful day of the Lord. Now, dyan ang galing yung idea or concept o mga prophecies tuwing meron paparating na nagpupula yung buwan, ay akala nila ay katapusan na ng mundo kasi nagpupula na yung buwan. Hindi, kadalasan, pag pupula yung buwan, ay kalagitnaan pa lang iyan na man. But this one is different. This is specific to a particular time. Yung sinasabing the great and dreadful day of the Lord. Now, careful study suggests the opposite. Yung last days seem to suggest to us an actual long period of time. In fact, yung tinatawag na last days sa scripture, it started when Christ came as a human being. Now, let's go and consider the following verses. Let's go to Hebrews chapter 1. Now, tingnan ninyo mabuti ito ha. The last days have already begun when Jesus Christ came as a human being. Hebrews chapter 1, beginning in verse 1. Sabi ng writer sa atin ng Hebrews, in the past, God spoke to our ancestors through the prophets at many times and in various ways. But in these last days, sabi niya, He has spoken to us by His Son. So you see, yung tinatawag sa scripture ng last days, it already began 2,000 years ago. The moment Jesus Christ began to deliver the message, whom He appointed heir of all things, and through whom also He made the universe. Okay, so hindi lamang last days yung pagdating ni Jesus Christ, we are also told that Jesus is going to be the heir and He is also the avenue by which the universe was created. And this verse clearly tells us that the last days already started with the coming of Jesus Christ in the flesh. Now, kaya natin nililinaw yung term na in the flesh because Jesus did not start coming here only 2,000 years ago. We know that He has been going up and down even in the days of the Old Testament. Pero kailangan malinaw tayo na yung tinatawag sa scripture ng last days is when He came as a human being. Yan yung sinasabi sa Hebrews. Now, verse 26. Hebrews 9, verse 26. Otherwise, Christ would have had to suffer many times since the creation of the world. But He has appeared once for all at the culmination of the ages, or the other translation says, in the last days, to do away with sin by the sacrifice of Himself. So even yung time, nililinaw sa atin, that when Jesus offered Himself as a sacrifice, that is the beginning of in the last days. The scripture describes the redemptive act of Christ as happening in the last days. Now, let's go to New Testament. Or another part of New Testament, sa Acts chapter 2. Dito, sa Pentecost, during Pentecost, si Peter quoted directly from the prophecy of Joel na binasa natin kanina. At that time, when the Holy Spirit is being poured at Pentecost, basahin natin yung sa Acts chapter 2, beginning in verse 14. Peter stood up with the 11, raised his voice, and addressed the crowd. And fellow Jews, sabi niya, all of you who live in Jerusalem, Let me explain this to you. Listen carefully to what I say. These people are not drunk, as you suppose. It's only 9 in the morning. Magtataka kayo kung bakit ganyan. Because this is the day of Pentecost. And in Israel, yung mga piyesta, maliban sa Day of Atonement, they consist of eating and drinking. Okay, and they are not drinking yung juice. Huh? They are really drinking strong wine na nakakalasing. Eh, Pentecost. So they are eating and they are drinking. Now, people think, because these people began to speak in different languages, ay naku, nalasing na. So Peter had to explain, hindi po, maaga pa, sabi niya. Kapag nagiinuman sila at 9 in the morning, hindi pa yan sila lasing. Pero nagiinuman na sila. This is what was spoken by the prophet Joel, sabi ni Peter. And then he quotes from Joel. In the last days, hindi binasa natin kanina, God says, I will pour out my spirit on all people. Your sons and daughters will prophesy. Your young men will see visions. Your old men will dream dreams. Even on my servants, both men and women, I will pour out my spirit in those days. And they will prophesy. Continue in Acts 2 verse 19. I will show wonders in the heavens above and signs on the earth below, blood and fire and billows of smoke. The sun will be turned to darkness and the moon to blood before the coming of the great and glorious day of the Lord. Everyone who calls on the name of the Lord will be saved. So dito, we are given 2 instances. At malinaw sa atin yung difference. Yung period of last days is when people will begin to dream dreams and see visions. Pero yung sinasabi niya specifically na the great and glorious day of the Lord, it will consist of the sun turning to darkness and the moon to blood. Yan. Verse 20. 1 Peter chapter 1, verse 20. He was chosen, that is Jesus, before the creation of the world, but he was revealed in these last times for your sake, or in the last days. Another one in James chapter 5, verses 2 to 4. Your wealth has rotted, and moths have eaten your clothes. Your gold and silver are corroded. Their corrosion will testify against you and eat your flesh like fire. You have hoarded wealth in the last days. So James, when he was writing, he was talking to the people of his time. Pero, dinidescribe niya yung time nila as already in the last days. Look, sabi niya, the wages you failed to pay the workers who mowed your fields are crying out against you. The cries of the harvesters have reached the ears of the Lord Almighty. Now, yung mga verses na binasa natin above, they indicate to us kung ano yung term na tinatawag na last days. When they started during the first advent of Christ up to the present. Now, that is why we know that today, we are already living in what is called in the last days. Nagpapatuloy siya. So, let's go to yung tinatawag naman na Day of the Lord. Basahin natin yung mga scriptures na nagsasabing tungkol dyan. The Day of the Lord is a separate and distinct event from the last days. So, basahin natin itong mga susunod na verses na ito. Beginning in 1 Thessalonians chapter 5. Beginning in verse 1. Sabi niya, brothers and sisters, about times and days, we do not need to write to you. For you know very well that the day of the Lord will come like a thief in the night. Okay, did you notice that? Yung tinatawag na day of the Lord is something we are told, biglaan siya, hindi mo siya inaasahan. Pero yung tinatawag na in the last days, you can actually see events happening around you. Okay. Pero pag ang dinidescribe na is this specific event, Day of the Lord, ang description siya sa kanya palagi, it's coming like a thief in the night. It's something you do not expect. While people are saying peace and safety, destruction will come on them suddenly, as labor pains on a pregnant woman. Okay. Let's clarify this. Noong araw, because people do not have the same, ano tawag dito, calculations and technology that we have, hindi nila na-predict kung kailan talaga manganganak yung isang buntis. Alam natin, on the 9th month. Pero they have no general concept kung kailan on the 9th month. Tayo today, we can actually tell up to the week kung kailan manganganak. We can generally tell today because of our technology. Pero noong araw, parang buntis yan. Hindi mo alam kung kailan talaga lalabas. Ako nga, hanggang ngayon, hindi ko pa rin alam kailan lalabas ito. Pero ganyan ang buntis noong araw. So that is why Jesus is using this analogy. People are saying peace and safety and destruction will come on them suddenly as labor pains on a pregnant woman. They will not escape. So dito, the day of the Lord is a reference to the actual coming. Yung in the last days are the events that lead to the coming of Christ. Pero yung day of the Lord na tinatawag, they refer to the actual days that He is going to come. Let's continue in 2 Thessalonians chapter 2, beginning in verse 1. Concerning the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ and our being gathered to Him, we ask you, brothers and sisters, not to become easily unsettled or alarmed by the teaching allegedly from us, whether by a prophecy or by word of mouth or by letter, asserting that the day of the Lord has already come. Now, did you notice that? Even at the days of Paul, marami ng mga false or fake news. Marami ng kumakalat. At ang sinasabi pa, sulat na galing mismo kaila Paul. Pero sabi ni Paul, huwag kayo maniwala dyan. Hindi totoo yan. Wala kami sinusulat na ganyan. And in verse 3, sabi niya, don't let anyone deceive you in any way, for that day will not come until the rebellion occurs and the man of lawlessness is revealed, the man doomed to destruction. Now, this time, the coming of the Lord, meron din siyang mga specific events na mangyayari along the way. Now, it is explicitly clear that the day of the Lord is the second coming. Tinatawag natin, the advent of Christ. And that is still in the future. For a clearer understanding of the difference between the last days and the day of the Lord, let's go to 2 Peter chapter 3, beginning in verse 3. Sabi ni Peter, above all, you must understand that in the last days, scoffers will come, scoffing and following their own evil desires. And they will say, where is this coming he promised? Ever since our ancestors died, everything goes on as it has since the beginning of creation. Kasi from the time that Jesus went back to heaven, up to the time Peter is writing his letter, marami nang naiinip. Marami nang naiinip. 20 to 30 years later, naiinip na sila. Kailan ba talaga darating? Nag-umpisa ako sa faith na ito, 30 years old ako. Ngayon 60 na ako, wala pa si Lord. Kailan ba? So they are wondering. At yan ang sabi ni Peter, kasama talaga yan, sabi niya. Verse 5. But they deliberately forget that long ago, by God's word, the heavens came into being, and the earth was formed out of water and by water. By these waters also the world of that time was deluged and destroyed. Si Peter was appealing to the power and the reliability of God's word. Sabi niya, if God was able to bring the creation into being just by saying it, sabi niya, kung sinasabi niya pagbabalik ni Jesus Christ, you can also believe and trust in it. Continue in verse 7, sabi niya, by the same word, the word that created the heavens and earth, by the same word, the present heavens and earth are reserved for fire, being kept for the day of judgment and the destruction of the ungodly. But do not forget this one thing, dear friends. With the Lord, a day is like a thousand years, and a thousand years are like a day. In other words, for a being that is immortal, the passage of time is immaterial. So pag sinabi ng Diyos na malapit na, we are not looking at our timing, we are looking at God's timing. And then he continues, the reason why it is still not yet coming is, verse 9, sabi niya, the Lord is not slow in keeping His promise, as some understand slowness. Instead, He is patient with you. So tayo pala yung dahilan kung bakit hindi pa bumabalik si Jesus Christ. And the reason is this, not wanting anyone to perish, but everyone to come to repentance. God has a certain plan of how many number of people to bring along with Him to reign and to rule. And for as long as the number and the people are not ready, God is willing to wait. Because God does not really want to lose people. Yun bang tatawag ka ng tao, bibigyan mo ng Holy Spirit, tapos pababayaan mo lang na mawala. That is not how God does things. If God calls you, and you respond through the waters of baptism, God gives you the Holy Spirit, God will wait so that you can be saved. Hindi yung, okay, bahala na yan. Darating si Jesus, kahit ready or not, here I come. That's not actually how God does things. God is also concerned because you are children. And God wants to save you. So He is not going to save Jesus if many people are still not ready. Until not yet. Okay. Because eventually, in the process of time, meron din naman sinasabing God is not going to wait anymore. Let's continue. Verse 10. But the day of the Lord will come like a thief. Ito na naman yan. You notice palagi yung description ng day of the Lord. Kahit sino ang nagsasabi niya, whether it is Jesus or Peter or Paul, they always call it like a thief in the night. Yung biglaan, yung hindi ka nakahanda, yung tulog ka. The heavens will disappear with a roar, the elements will be destroyed by fire, and the earth and everything done in it will be laid bare. So, the last days started at the time of the first coming of Jesus Christ as a human being. And yung tinatawag na day of the Lord refers to the actual coming of Christ. So, tandaan natin yun na, last days are a series of events that lead to the return of Jesus Christ. Pero yung tinatawag na day of the Lord is the specific time period na kung saan talagang bababa na si Jesus Christ. Now, this distinction will help us identify later on kung nasaan na tayo doon sa prophetic timeline ng Diyos. So, let's look at this prophecy timeline. Let's read beginning in verse 1 of Matthew 24. Now, most of you would have read this many times over, pero daanan natin siya ulit. Matthew 24, beginning in verse 1. Jesus left the temple and was walking away when His disciples came up to Him to call His attention to its buildings. Ito yung temple na ginawa ni Herod. Yung kay Solomon was destroyed, it was rebuilt, and then ni-rebuild ulit ni Herod. So sabi niya, do you see all these things? That's Jesus talking, He asked. Truly I tell you, not one stone here will be left on another, on top of another. Everyone will be thrown down. As Jesus was sitting on the Mount of Olives, the disciples came to Him privately. So this is a private conversation between Jesus and the disciples. Walang maraming crowd dito. Tell us, sabi niya. Tell us, they said, when will this happen? What will be the sign of your coming and of the end of the age? So dito sa Matthew 24 na ito, which is called the Olivet Prophecy, the disciples of Jesus actually ask Him three questions. The first question is, when is the destruction of the temple? Now the temple we know was destroyed by the Roman army in around 70 AD. That's during the time of General Titus. And it's still in ruins today. Pag tinignan nyo ngayon yan, hindi yung temple ang makikita ninyo. Ang makikita ninyo ay yung Dome of the Rock ng mga Muslim. Oo. Pangalawang tanong nila is, what are the signs of the end? Paano namin malalaman kung paparating na tayo sa dulo? And the question refers to yung tinatawag na last days. The third question na tinatanong nila is, anong mga signs kapag ikaw ay babalik na? Paano namin malalaman? And that question, of course, refers to that specific time period na tinatawag na the Day of the Lord. Yan. Ang new response ni Jesus, you will find, mababasa natin yan in the following verses, was very precise and accurate. Matthew chapter 24, verse 4 to 14, answers the question about the last days, while Matthew 24, 15 to 31, answers the question about the Day of the Lord. We will go through it very quickly. Jesus answered, beginning in verse 4, sabi niya, watch out that no one deceives you. For many will come in my name, claiming I am the Messiah, and will deceive many. In other translations, I am the Christ. Pero pareho lang yan. Christ is the Greek word, and the Hebrew word is Messiah. Okay, sa atin yan, ang tawag natin dyan, Christo or Messias. But they actually mean the same thing. One is Greek, the other is Hebrew. Messiah is Hebrew, and Christ is Greek.
Christos.
Oh, pero ang direct translation niyan is the anointed, the one chosen by God. Now, kailangan malinaw tayo dyan kasi nasanay tayo na tinatawag si Jesus na Jesus Christ. Akala natin Jesus is first name and Christ is last name. Pero hindi yan. Jesus Christ means Jesus the anointed or the king that was chosen by God to lead the people. Kaya, pwede rin i-translate yan, Jesus the King. Okay. Let's continue. Sabi niya, you will hear of wars and rumors of wars, but see to it that you are not alarmed. Such things must happen, but the end is still to come. So, sinasabi ni Jesus yung events na tinatawag ng mga prophets in the last days. Ano yan? Ito yan. Many will come in my name, claiming I am the Messiah, and will deceive many. You will hear of wars and rumors of wars, but see to it that you are not alarmed. Sabi niya, huwag kayong mag-alala pa dyan. Such things must happen, pero the end is still to come. Hindi pa, sabi niya. Nation will rise against nation, kingdom against kingdom. Magkakaroon talaga ng mga gera worldwide. There will be famines and earthquakes in various places. Uy, padalas ng padalas yung mga ano, ha? Yung mga lindol. Recently, meron na naman. Dito pa sa atin palagi. Well, kasama kasi tayo sa tinatawag na Ring of Fire. Marami tayong mga faults dito. Pero meron talaga yan. There will be famines and earthquakes in various places. Pero ang sabi ni Jesus, all these are the beginning of birth pains. Umpisa pa lang yan. The end of the age, or the last days, nag-umpisa na siya, pero the end is not yet. Nag-umpisa pa lang yung ating mga sakit-sakit. Sabi niya, it is only the beginning of birth pains. Which is a reference to yung panganak na kapag nararamdaman mo ng sumasakit-sakit, alam mo na malapit ka ng manganak. Verse 14, this gospel of the kingdom will be preached in the whole world as a testimony to all nations. And then, sabi niya, the end will come. So when you see, ito na yan, umpisa na siya mag-describe ng the end or the day of the Lord. So when you see the standing in the holy place, the abomination that causes desolation, spoken of through the prophet Daniel, let the reader understand. Yeah, okay. Yung tinatawag na holy place dyan, that is yung temple in Jerusalem, which today is not yet. But the prophecy says that you will see someone or something standing in the holy place. Yung abomination that causes desolation spoken of through the prophet Daniel. Nasaan niya? Let the reader understand. Then let those who are in Judea flee to the mountains. Let no one on the housetop go down to take anything out of the house. Now, Judea is the general area na kung saan nandun ngayon ang tinatawag natin na Israel. That is why, sinasabi ko kanina, ang talagang binabantayan natin dyan are the events na nakasentro sa Jerusalem. Because this is the center of prophecy. Sabi niya, let those who are in Judea flee to the mountain. Let no one on the housetop go down to take anything out of the house. Let no one in the field go back to get their cloak. How dreadful it will be in those days for pregnant women and nursing mothers. Pray that your flight will not take place in winter or on the Sabbath. Okay, bakit ini-emphasize ni Jesus yan? Kasi the events na sinasabi dito is that Jerusalem will be the center of these events happening. Pag nasa labas ka ng Jerusalem daw o ng Judea, huwag ka nang magtangka pa na pumasok. Kapag ikaw naman ay nandoon sa loob, pilitin mo makatakas. Dalawa lang daw ang dapat katakutan mo. Kapag itong events na ito ay nangyari during winter, or kapag ang events na ito ay nangyari during the Sabbath. The reason for that, pag winter, lalabas ka ng Jerusalem, you're going to die. Kasi the entire surrounding area ay puro yelo yan. You cannot go very far. You will not survive. Kaya sabi niya, you pray that these events will not happen during winter. The other one is the Sabbath. Because even today, there is a distance kung saan pwede kang maglakad on the Sabbath in the streets of Jerusalem. Ang sabi nila, kunin mo yung sapatos mo at ihagis mo. Kung saan umabot yan, yun lang ang tinatawag na Sabbath days journey. Yan lang ang pwede mong lakarin. Anything beyond that, may mababato na sa'yo. Okay. Ganyan ang sa kanila. And during the days of Jesus, ang lakas niyan. So that is the warning. Sabi niya, pray that your flight, pray that these events do not happen in winter or they do not happen on the Sabbath, so that you can escape. Ayan. Verse 21, for then there will be great distress, unequal from the beginning of the world until now, and never to be equal again. In other words, itong time period na sinasabi ni Jesus, it has not happened before, it will not happen again. Which means this is a unique event in history. A unique event in history na kung saan kapag nakita mo siya, wala kang comparison from before. And it will not happen again. Sabi niya, if those days have not been cut short, no one would survive. In other words, this is a really terrible time. People will be dying left and right. And if God does not step in to cut it short, we're all going to die. Sabi niya, mauubos kayo lahat. No one would survive, but for the sake of the elect, kayo yan, those days will be shortened. Because God also has a promise, and I'm sure most of you has that promise in your heart as a favorite. God will not test you beyond what you are able. At yan din yung promise na yan. Sabi niya, for the sake of the elect, those days will be shortened. God will not allow you to be tormented or running around hanggang hindi mo na kaya. Kakayanin nyo. At that time, if anyone says to you, look, here is the Messiah, or there he is. Or look, the Messiah is in Mindanao. Ayaw kayo maniwala dyan, sabi niya. Hindi totoo yan. Bakit? Verse 24. For false messiahs and false prophets will appear and perform great signs and wonders to deceive, if possible, even the elect. Okay, so linawin natin konti yan. Yung tinatawag sa scripture na Messiah is a king claiming to be the God who will save Israel. At ang sinasabi ni Jesus, maraming liligtaw na ganyan. People who will claim that they are the Christ, that they are the Savior, that they are Jesus. Meron din tayo niya, local. Pero hindi totoo yan. Okay, malinaw yan sa scripture. Sabi niya, huwag kayong maniwala dyan. See, sabi niya, I have told you ahead of time. Pinapangunahan ko na kayo. Kaya kung meron magsasabi sa inyo, antimano, nakataas agad ang depensa niyo. Hindi totoo yan. Now dito, Jesus Christ was clearly talking about two distinct and separate events. The last days that started with His first coming, and the day of the Lord that is yet to start, immediately leading to His return. So, let's go now to Revelation para ma-compare natin yung Matthew 24 at saka yung sinasabi sa Revelation. Now, since the time Jesus spoke about the sign of the end of the age, mankind has always wanted to know the exact timing. No, marami sa atin yan. Babasa natin yan from time to time sa internet. In fact, alam na kalat yun sa Facebook. In fact, tuwing pumula yung buwan, everybody is prophesying. Ito na yan. Mankind has always wanted to know the exact timing and the apocalyptic events that would lead to the end of the world. Prophecies, we need to understand, are not to be interpreted privately. We must allow the Bible to interpret itself. Kasi ang Bible, ini-explain niya yung sarili niya symbols at ini-explain din niya yung mga events. And if we have no idea kung anong sinasabi diyan, God will always send prophets to explain it to us. Jesus did not leave the Olivet prophecy hanging. Rather, He provided to us details to the prophecy in the book of Revelation. The book of Revelation of Jesus Christ is given to the Apostle John concerning things that are to soon take place. Basahin natin yan, Revelation chapter 1, beginning verse 1. The revelation from Jesus Christ. Okay, revelation is an English word. Ang Greek word niyan ay apocalypse. Okay, ma-discuss din natin yan. But apocalypse, so that you will have a general idea, hindi ibig sabihin end of the world. Apocalypse means revelation.
To reveal.
Oh, para may pakita. Kailangan malinasan kasi, marami tayong narinig kapag mayroong mga events, lindol o ano, hala, apocalypse na. Okay, hindi ganyan. Pwede mong sabihin, hala, end of the world na. Pero apocalypse is different. Apocalypse simply means revelation. Apocalypse is Greek. Revelation is English. Para sa atin yan, pagpapaliwanag o pagpapakita sa Tagalog. Okay. The revelation from Jesus Christ, which God gave Him to show His servants what must soon take place. He made it known by sending His angel to His servant John, who testifies to everything he saw, and that is the Word of God and the testimony of Jesus Christ. Blessed is the one who reads aloud the words of this prophecy, and blessed are those who hear it and take to heart what is written in it, because the time is near. So the book of Revelation reveals events that are soon to take place, a time that is in our near future. It is a book that provides clarity and detail to the Olivet prophecies of Jesus. So, tingnan natin yung sequence. The book of Revelation is not a book of mystery. Kasi pag binabasa natin iyan, ang sinasabi sa atin na paliwanag ay huwag mo nang pagsulikapan o nawahin iyan kasi misteryoso iyan. But that is not the intent of the book of Revelation. Its intent is to reveal. It is a book that is intended to be understood by the readers. It is a book that contains the revelation of Jesus Christ to the church. The book of Revelation is not difficult to understand, and Jesus shows us the blow-by-blow account of things that are going to happen. The key to understanding the book of Revelation is to read it sequentially. Huwag kayong talon-talon. Babasa kayo dito sa chapter 1, tapos tapalun kayo sa kabilang chapter. Chapter, mag-i-skip kayo ng chapter. Huwag ganyan. When you are reading the book of Revelation, you read it sequentially. And you will find that the prophecies in the book of Revelation, they are laid out in a sequence of sevens. God has a thing for the number seven. You will notice that in many things in the scripture. Even in the days of creation, seven din siya. 1 to 6, creation of the earth and everything in it. And then the seventh is the resting. Now, in Revelation, ganyan din ang ginawa ng Diyos. Meron din siyang series of sevens. Meron tinatawag na seven seals. Sa dulo ng seven seal, meron tinatawag na seven trumpets. Sa dulo ng trumpets, ay may tinatawag na seven plagues. Now, that is God's style of presentation. Pag naiintindihan niyo yan, it is easier to understand Revelation. In this manner, you will be able to appreciate and fully comprehend the prophecies revealed by Christ to His people sa pamamagitan ni Apostle John. So let's start doon sa Revelation chapter 6. Kasi yung first few chapters, they are mostly messages to the churches. Kung anong mga mensahe sa kanila ni Jesus, kung anong mga pagkukulang nila, kung anong mga dapat ayusin nila sa buhay-buhay nila. But the seals, they actually begin in Revelation chapter 6. And for our purposes, mag-umpisa na tayo doon sa 5th. Revelation chapter 6 beginning in verse 9. When he opened the 5th seal, I saw under the altar the souls of those who had been slain because of the word of God and the testimony they had maintained. They called out in a loud voice, "How long, sovereign Lord, holy and true, will you judge the inhabitants of the earth and avenge our blood?" Now, this is one thing I would like for you to notice dito sa statement na ito. Because most people misunderstand yung 5th seal. Akala nila 5th seal is the great tribulation only. But, ang sabi dito, the 5th seal already began when these people who are dead before had already started praying. It's symbol, yung blood, parang katulad iyan ng blood ni Abel that is falling out in the ground, calling for vengeance. Yung 5th seal, the moment it was opened by Jesus, the prayers of the people who are already dead. Okay, yan ang opening ng 5th seal. Kailangan naiintindihan natin yan. The prayers of these people went up to God at ang sabi, hanggang kailan kami mananatili dito? When will you avenge us? And in verse 11, ito ang sabi. Each of them was given a white robe and they were told, wait a little longer. Okay, so parang merong seremonya na pinapanood tayo. These people who are already dead, in symbols, nagdadasal sila. Pero instead na pagbigyan yung kahilingan agad nila ng vengeance, ito, suot nyo muna ito. White robes, until, sabi niya, the full number of their fellow servants, their brothers and sisters, were killed, just as they had been. Okay, the 5th seal, the opening of the 5th seal, talks about dead people asking for vengeance, but it also talks about people who are alive and are going to be killed. Yan, gusto mo ba ba mabaptize? Ito, ang naghihintay sa'yo. Some of the people, in the future, they will actually face death. Well, whichever comes first. Natural death for these events. Pero hindi naman kayo lahat mamamatay. Remember ang sabi ni Jesus, you will not be tested beyond what you are able. If death is going to be detrimental for you, will prevent you from being saved, you will not die. Jesus will make sure that you survive to the end. Death will not be your test. the persecution will be. Okay, kasama-sama na lahat yan dyan. Pero yan ang sinasabi. Ang sabi sa kanila, maghintay muna kayo until the rest of the fellow servants who will give up their lives are dead. Yan. So meron yan. At yan ang sinasabi sa fifth seal. The moment Jesus opens the fifth seal, people, true Christians, will start dying. Meron talaga yan. And continue in verse 12. Sabi niya, and as I watched, okay, so pagkatapos nitong event na ito, papasok na yung tinatawag na sixth seal. I watched as he opened the sixth seal, there was a great earthquake, the sun turned black like sackcloth made of gold hair, the whole moon turned blood red. Okay, tingnan ninyo yung sequence ng events, ha? Yung fifth is the martyrdom of saints. And immediately, pagpasok niya, yung sixth is yung mga supernatural events in the sky. Okay. So kung pagpasok ng mga buwan, napupula yung moon, pero wala namang great martyrdom of saints, hindi ba iyan? And that's one of the things na people are always confused. Tuwing makakabalita sila sa Facebook, sa Facebook nga, ang dami ng kulay ng moon. Eh. Meron ng blue, meron ng green, meron ng pula, okay. Pero hindi yan. Because the events that are being discussed in Revelation are events that immediately follow a great number of death of true Christians. Now, kung wala pa sa inyong namamatay dyan, hindi lang pinipersecute for your life, kahit ilang beses pang pumula yung buwan during the course of the year, that is not yet the end. Hindi ito yan. Pero this event describes the second coming of Jesus Christ. Totoo naman yan. The turning of the moon into blood really represents the coming of the Lord. Kaya lang, meron siyang malinaw na event before that. And for as long as wala yung event na iyan, then any turning of the moon to red has nothing to do with prophecy. Relax lang kayo. Bumili pa rin kayo ng bigas. Bumili pa rin kayo ng tilapia. At magluto pa rin kayo. Okay. Ganyan yan. Okay. Please continue. Sabi niya, I watched as he opened the sixth seal. There was a great earthquake. The sun turned black like sackcloth made of gold hair. The whole moon turned blood red. The stars in the sky fell to earth as figs drop from a fig tree when shaken by a strong wind. The heavens receded like a scroll being rolled up, and every mountain and island was removed from its place. So this is a really strong earthquake. Can you imagine kung yung mga islands nakalipat-lipat na sa iba-ibang lugar? Earthquake yan, ang lakas niya. Oo, nagkanda usog-usog yung mga islands. At yung mga mountains, nagkanda patag-patag. Okay. Then, verse 15, the kings of the earth, the princes, the generals, the rich, the mighty, and everyone else, both slave and free, hid in caves and among the rocks of the mountains. They called to the mountains and the rocks, fall on us and hide us from the face of him who sits on the throne and from the wrath of the Lamb. For the day of their great wrath has come, and who can withstand it? Okay, so it tells us that when these events happen, it is unmistakable. You will know that it is the doing of God. Hindi mo siya may attribute into, ay, normal lang yan, natural event lang yan, parang yun namang nangyayari yan. But when these events happen, the kings of the earth, the princes, the generals, the rich, the mighty, and everyone else, sabi niya, they will know that this is the work of God. Magtatabo na yan sila in the caves, in the rocks. Sabi niya, the great day of the wrath has come, and who can withstand it? Okay, so let's have a little bit of a visual ng tinatawag na seven seals. Let's go through it very quickly. Yung tinatawag na first seal refers to the false Christ and the deceivers. Yan yung mababasa ninyo sa Matthew 24. At yan yung mababasa din ninyo sa beginning ng Revelation 6. Tandaan na din natin ulit ito mamaya Kung gusto po ninyo magkaroon ng kopya nito na nakikita ninyo dyan, kapitan nyo na lang ako mamaya. And then maybe I can share it to you. Pwede natin kuhanan ng screenshot yan. Para lang mabilis tayo kasi this is going to be a very long discussion. Let's jump. So in Matthew 24, beginning in verse 4, Jesus sabi niya, doon sa first scene, watch out that no one deceives you, for many will come in my name, claiming I am the Messiah, and will deceive many. Okay, ang equivalent niyan ay nandun sa Revelation chapter 6, beginning in verse 1. Sabi niya, I watch as the Lamb opened the first of the seven seals. So what you have here is a scroll. Pero yung scroll, unique siya, kasi bago mo ma-open yung isang portion, merong seal. Pero doon sa kasunod na part, meron ulit seal. So this is not a scroll na kapag in-open mo yung seal, bukas lahat. Bawat portion, merong seal. And there is apparently four seals. Now, kapag binasa ninyo yung chapters 4 and 5, you will find there is only one that can open the seal. And siya yung tinatawag na Lamb. Now, alam natin na Lamb is a representation of Jesus Christ. Yan kasi ang writing style ni John. He likes to describe Jesus in symbols. It does not mean that Jesus is a Lamb. Na yung tupa talaga, yun bang mukhang Lamb. Hindi rin ganun. Now, kaya ko pinapaliwanan sa inyo yan, because people think that just because Jesus is called the Word, that it means he is just a salita. Pero hindi, ito ang writing style ni John. He likes to describe Jesus as the Word, the Lamb, the Lion. Yun ba? Pero hindi ibig sabihin na Lion talaga siya, o Lamb talaga siya, o salita lang talaga siya. It is how he is called, how he is described. Para bang alias. Parang ako, pag dito sa inyo, you call me Rene. Pero pag sa bahay, ang tawag niya sa akin, Toto. Toto is the Ilonggo for boy. Okay. Now, kayo din, meron din kayong mga ganyan katawagan. For some reason, yung original na pangalan niyo at yung tawag sa, yung nickname niyo ang layo. But that is how people call you. Parang si Peter din. Peter, kapag nung pinangalanan si Jesus Christ, eh sabi sa kanya, oh, ikaw, you are Cephas, meaning a small stone, pebble, yung batong maliit. Parang yung dalawa din na pinsan niya, si James at saka si John, mga anak ng Kulog. Meaning yung tatay nila, ang tawag sa tatay nila, Kulog. Ito na si Kulog. Okay. Pero hindi ibig sabihin yung tatay nila ay Kulog. Okay. But that is how people call it now. Kaya ko nililinan sa inyo yan because you might misunderstand. Just because the scripture calls Jesus the Word, ang ibig sabihin, ano lang siya?
Salita.
Hindi, alias lang yan. In the same way that he is also called the Lamb, he is also called the Lion of Judah. See? Okay, yung malinaw tayo dyan ha. Jesus is a real person. He opened the seal. At ito yung first seal. Sabi niya, I watch as the Lamb opened the first of the seven seals. I'm trying very much na, kasi baka i-imagine ninyo, meron scroll, tapos meron tupa na naglalakad dyan, tapos kilagat yung ano?
Ay, sinyo.
Kilagat yung seal. Hindi ganyan. Tao pa rin naman yan. Forma tao na binuksan talaga yung seal. Kaya lang, ang tawag sa kanya ni John, the Lamb. Okay. Hindi yan tupa na naglalakad tapos kinagat yung seal. Okay. Then sabi niya, I heard one of the four living creatures say in a voice like thunder, come. I looked, and there before me was a white horse. Its rider held a bow, and he was given a crown, and he rode out as a conqueror bent on conquest. So this is a rider na mayroong bow. Tapos binigyan ng corona. Bakit? Eh kasi sabi nga, di ba, he will proclaim himself as a Christ, as a Messiah. But watch out, sabi niya, he will deceive many, but he is not the true Messiah. Umpisa pa lang yan. At yan yung makikita natin doon sa yung yellow. na graph, which is false Christ. At ang sinasabi sa atin, maraming nilitaw yan in the future. And that is not new. Even before Jesus Christ came on the scene, meron na lang nag-claim na sila yung Messiah. The reason for that is simple. The Messiah is a person who is a descendant of the king, David, who has a claim to the throne. Kaya marami talaga nag-claim yan. And this false Christ, magpapatuloy yan even after Jesus Christ. They will continue to claim that. And we are looking to that dito sa first scene. Okay, let's continue. Matthew 24 verse 6, sabi niya, "You will hear of wars and rumors of wars, but see to it that you are not alarmed. Such things must happen, but the end is still to come. Nation will rise against nation, and kingdom against kingdom. There will be famines and earthquakes in various places." Now, ang equivalent niyan ay yung second seal sa Revelation, chapter 6. You will find na yung Matthew 24 is an exact copy of Revelation. Pareho sila. "When the Lamb opened the second seal, I heard the second living creature say, 'Come.' Then another horse came out, a fiery red one. Its rider was given power to take peace from the earth and to make people kill its other. To him was given a large sword." So ang nire-represent niyan is war. Now, dalawa na ngayon silang tumatakbo. A white horse na mayroong rider na may hawak na po at may corona. And alongside, tumatakbo na din itong red horse. Parang alak lahat na. Okay. So, white horse, may red horse. Okay. "To him was given a large sword." Now, ang equivalent naman yan, second seal, ay yung wars and rumors of wars na nabasa natin sa Matthew 24. Sa Revelation chapter 6, yan naman ang counterpart niya. Okay, now let's continue. Matthew 24, verse 7. "From the part where Jesus said, 'Nation will rise against nation and kingdom against kingdom,' sabi niya, 'There will be famines and,'" continuing, "'earthquakes in various places.'" Now, pagdating natin sa Revelation chapter 6, verse 5, the opening of the third seal. Sabi niya, "I heard the third living creature say, 'Come.' I looked, and there before me was a black horse. Its rider was holding a pair of scales in his hand." Okay, black horse naman ngayon. Pero mayroong hawak yung rider na scales, timbangan. Oo. "I heard what sounded like a voice among the four living creatures saying, 2 pounds of wheat for a day's wages." Ano yung 2 pounds of wheat? Isang kilo ng wheat. Yun ang sweldo mo sa isang araw.
Isang kilo bigas.
Can you imagine that? Pag dumating yung time na ang amount ng sweldo mo ay halaga lang ng isang kilo bigas. Magkano yan? Isang kilo? 30?
45?
40? 45? O sabihin na natin 50 or 60. Ngayon, ganyan ang klase. Pero yan ang, this is the timing na sinasabi dyan. It will come to a point where ang kikitain nyo lang sa isang araw ay tama lang na pambili ng bigas. Isang kilo bigas. Can you imagine kung ilang kayong membro sa pamilya? 3, 4, 5. Eh ako lang, 1 kilo. Tama lang yun sa akin. Usually, isang kainan lang yan.
Isang kilo lang.
Mauubos ko yan. Namumulat ako eh. Kasi yung pag kumakain ako sa bahay, yung isang kaldero, nakakalahati ako. Hindi pa kumakain yung iba eh. Okay. Okay. Nakita niyo naman ang resulta, ba? Okay. Pero yan ang sinasabi dito. It's going to go very bad. Na ang susweldohin mo lang sa isang araw, the resources are going to be very small, short, kulang, di kahos. Na ang susweldohin mo lang talaga ay 1 kilo bigas. That's as much as you will get. But you will find na itong events na dinidescribe ni Jesus, they are in progression of worsening condition. It is a natural effect of war. Because when war happens,
inflation.
Oh, yung devastation ng natural resources, normal yan. Plus, because nothing can go in, nothing can go out, eh yung pagkain mo, walang makakarating, walang makalabas. Or kung ano na lang yung nandyan. At a time of war, kung ano lang yung supply na meron ka, maghahati-hati kayo niyan. And that is what is described. In other words, itong dinidescribe ni Jesus na klase ng gera, it will become so bad. It is not the war that we are experiencing today. It is a kind of war that resources will really go very, very low. And you are willing, you are going to be willing to work for a kilo of rice for a day. Okay, continue. Sabi niya, 6 pounds of barley for a day's wages. And do not damage the oil and the wine. Yan ang situation. Now, we know that in Jesus' statement in Matthew 24, this represents yung tinatawag na panim. Yan. And, continuing on, verse 7 also talks about earthquakes in various places. Pero hindi lamang yan. In Revelation chapter 6, verse 7 to 8, when the Lamb opened the fourth seal, I heard the voice of the fourth living creature say, come. I looked, and there before me was a pale horse. Okay, so ito na yung pang-apat. Ito yung, kung nakikita nyo sa mga write-up, eh, tinatawag na four horsemen of the Apocalypse. Okay, the white horse, the red horse, the black horse, and the pale horse. Lahat yan merong rider. And lahat yan, they represent events. When the Lamb opened the fourth seal, I heard the voice of the fourth living creature say, come. I looked, and there before me was a pale horse. Its rider was named Death. And Hades was following close behind him. Hades, in this particular instance, ay libingan. Yan bang kapag mayroong namatay, kasunod na din yung libingan. Hindi ka pa namatay, nakahanda na kung saan kayo hugulog. Okay. They were given power over a fourth of the earth. So, take note ha, a fourth of the earth. To kill by sword, famine, and plague, and by the wild beasts of the earth. Which is also a natural consequence of war and famine. Kasi ang kasunod niyan, magkakasakit ka dahil hindi ka na kumakain ng maayos. And, dami-dami na yan. Kapag ka hindi sapat ang pagkain mo, eh yung resistance ng katawan mo ay mababa din. So very susceptible ka na sa mga sakit-sakit. Diba? Swerte natin mga matataba ngayon dahil yung iba nakakatagutom na tayo, mapayos pa lang. Okay. So may advantage din pala. Yung medyo mataba ngayon, chubby. Dahil yung iba ay eh, talagang nangangayayat na ng gusto, tayo, mapayat pa lang. Matutupad na rin yung pangarap yung napapayat kayo. Okay. Yan yung epekto ng disease and or disease epidemics. Yan. Of course, we are told that the worst epidemics happened in the last 1,000 years. Pero remember, ang description nitong events na ito na sinasabi ni Jesus, it has never happened before. It will never happen again. In other words, Jesus is describing of a time that something definitely worse. Not before, not ever. Unique in the history. And then, papasok na yung tinatawag na fifth seal. Okay, let's continue in Matthew 24, beginning in verse 8. Sabi niya, yung first four horsemen na yon, they are the beginning of birth pains. When, hindi ito yung horses na kapag tumakbo yung isa, mawawala na yung isa. Hindi. These are horses that are running together side by side. Naulanan siya yung isa. When the conqueror runs, war will come behind him. Susunod yan sa kanya. And then the ravages of war will be famine. The ravages of famine will be disease and epidemics. Habang tumatakbo yan, at habang papalapit iyan sa finish line, it becomes stronger and sabi natin, mas matindi. Because alam niyo naman yung kapag kayo nanonood ng karera, gumaragasa, habang paparating iyan doon sa finish line, talagang
intensity.
Oo, ang bibilis na ng takbo niyan. The intensity is very strong. Okay. 24 verse 8, sabi ni Jesus, all these are the beginning of birth pains. Kapag tumatakbo na yung apat na iyan, umpisa pa lang yan ng mga sakit-sakit. Sabi niya. Then, Jesus now describes the fifth seal. You will be handed over to be persecuted and put to death. Sabi niya, you will be hated by all nations because of me. In other words, kayo mga tunay na Kristiyano, kayo ang babagsakan ng sisi. Kung bakit nangyayari lahat ng mga masasamang bagay na ito, kasi ito si Helen yan eh, at saka si Armel yan eh, at saka si Franny, yan mga yan, sila ang nangyayari lahat ng ito. You will find that this is the same event that happened during the days of Nero. When Rome was burned by Nero himself, ang binagsakan ng sisi, yung mga Kristiyano. But that is common. When bad things happen, people need to find someone to blame. People will always find someone to blame. And in this particular period of time, kayo, iyan, mababagsakan ng sisi. You will be handed over to be persecuted and put to death. You will be hated by all nations because of me, sabi niya. Because of your belief in the true Christ. At that time, verse 10, many will turn away from the faith and will betray and hate each other. Ito na parting nakakalungkot niyan. Because Jesus actually predicted that when bad things begin to happen and when Christians begin to be blamed, they will feel bad. Bakit ako? Hindi ako, ito misis ko. Sabi niya, sumasama lang naman ako sa kanya eh. Pero siya talaga ang nandiyan sa ano na yan. Sa Church of God na yan. See? Yan. Nagkaroon tayo ng mga pagkaroon kayo mga asawa na hindi faithful. Dahil naniniwala silang walang forever. Okay. Kayo ngayon ang ituturo. Ito yan. Yung wife ko, siya yan. O ito yan, yung mister ko. So kasama lang naman ako sa kanya. Siyempre, yung mister ko siya. Pero hindi talaga ako ang Kristiyano. Siya. O yan. Ito yan. And this is sad, by the way. When people are being tested for their faithfulness, some will fail. And I hope that you are not part of that some. I hope that you are part of those who will be willing to stand and be willing to give up your life for your faith. Pero, ito ang warning ni Jesus. It is given to you ahead of time so that you can be prepared. So that you can strengthen your resolve. That when these things happen, kayo din mga bata, when these things happen, hindi nyo ituturo yung nanay ko, yung tatay ko. Isa yan, isa din siya. Yan. You will be willing to stand by your faith. That you will not betray and hate each other. Many false prophets will appear and deceive many people. In other words, when these events begin to happen, maglilitawan na din yung mga ano? Mga nagpo-propeta. Yeah, marami yan in the future. Because of the increase of wickedness, the love of most will grow cold. Panlalamig ng puso. And ito yan din describe sa Revelation chapter 6 in verse 9. When he opened the fifth seal, I saw under the altar the souls of those who had been slain because of the word of God and the testimony they had maintained. In other words, these are people previously who had already been persecuted and died. Kasama na dyan yung mga apostles. Yung iba sa kanila pinako sa cross, yung iba sa kanila pinugutan ng ulo, yung iba sa kanila sinunog sa oil. Ayan. And the testimony they have maintained, they called out in a loud voice, "How long, sovereign Lord, holy and true, until you judge the inhabitants of the earth and avenge our blood?" Sabi nila, symbolic. Remember, this is symbolic. It's like the blood of Abel crying out in the ground, crying for vengeance. At ang sagot sa kanila, ay verse 11, each of them was given a white robe. Okay, so tinuna ito, white robe. And they were told, maghintay muna kayo, konti pa. Until the full number of their fellow servants, their brothers and sisters were killed, just as they had been. Sabi niya, hindi pa sapat yan. Meron pang kasama sa inyo dyan. Yan yung fifth seal. Okay, ito yan. Fifth seal. Okay, let's continue. Immediately, verse Matthew 24, verse 29, immediately after this tribulation, martyrdom, after the distress of those days, the sun will be darkened, the moon will not give its light. Ito na yan. The stars will fall from the sky, the heavenly bodies will be shaken. I watched, Revelation 6, ito yung equivalent niya, Revelation 6, verse 12. I watched as he opened the sixth seal, there was a great earthquake. Oh, by the way, hindi ito mayayari sa isang araw lang, ha? This is a long period of time. I watched as he opened the sixth seal, there was a great earthquake. The sun turned black like sackcloth made of goat hair. The whole moon turned blood red. The stars in the sky fell to earth as twigs drop from a fig tree when shaken by a strong wind. The heavens receded like a scroll being rolled up, and every mountain and island was removed from its place. Then the kings of the earth, the princes, the generals, the rich, the mighty, and everyone else, both slave and free, hid in caves and among the rocks of the mountains. At this point in time, kahit anong bahay, kahit anong ganda pa ng bahay, ang tinitirhan mo, eh wala na siyang kwenta. It will not save you. It does not mean na hindi na kayo bibili ng mga bahay ngayon, ha? Wala naman ako sinasabing ganyan. Ang sinasabi ko lang, during this particular time, it will be useless. Pero hindi naman kayo yan. Kayo talagang nagtatago na kayo sa buhay ninyo. Hindi naman kayo kasama dito. This is talking of the people who are different from you. Kayo yung persecuted. Sila yung persecutors. But this time, God's vengeance is beginning. Sila naman ang magtatago, kayo naman ang safe. Okay. Yan. Verse 16. They called to the mountains and the rocks, fall on us and hide us from the face of him who sits on the throne and from the wrath of the Lamb. For the great day of their wrath has come, and who can withstand it? Okay, yan yung sixth seal. Yan yung tinatawag na heavenly signs. Okay. Now, pagkatapos niyan, papasok naman yung ginatawag na trumpets. Now, the trumpets, they consist of seven, and they start beginning in Revelation chapter 8. Now, magpasa na lang natin itong chart na ito. Tingnan nyo na lang iyan mamaya. Let's go to Revelation chapter 8, beginning in verse 7. Now, remember that there are seven seals. The moment that the seventh seal is open, nakahilera na yung seven trumpets. Okay. At ito naman yan. The first trumpet. The first angel, Revelation 8, verse 7, sounded his trumpet, and there came hail and fire mixed with blood, and it was hurled down on the earth. A third of the earth was burned up, a third of the trees were burned up, and all the green grass was burned up. Kanina, doon sa war, one-fourth of the earth was annihilated. This time naman, yung natural
resources.
Sabi niya, a third of the earth, a third of the trees, a third of the grass was burned. Yan yung first trumpet. Pagpasok ng second trumpet, pag nadudod kayo sa setting na sinasabi ni John, parang nanonood kayo ng isang mahabang ceremony na mayroong mga angels, may apat dyan na nasa gitna, tapos mayroong seven angels na may hawak na bawat trumpet. I-imagine nyo na lang yan. This is what John was seeing in heaven. And as its angel sounded his trumpet, si John, pagtingin niya sa earth, mayroong mga cataclysmic events na nangyayari doon sa earth. Si John, pinapanood niya lang at dinidescribe niya sa atin yung series of events. The second angel sounded his trumpet, and something like a huge mountain, all ablaze, was thrown into the sea. So ang nakikita ni John, parang malaking bundok, sabi niya, pero nag-aapoy. Of course, yan ang nakikita ni John from heaven going to earth. Pag tayo ang nakatingin niya from earth, eh para tayo nakakakita ng isang pagkalaki-laking ball of fire. Usually, yung mga maliliit na comets na pumapasok sa atin, nasusunog yan eh. Bago siya makarating doon sa earth, talagang maliliit na lang siya. So it does not cause heavy damage. Pero this one is different. This one is really big. Sabi niya, oh, parang bundok. Can you imagine from heaven all the way to earth? Nakikita pa rin dyan, parang bundok ang laki. Sabi niya. And, sabi niya, it was thrown to the sea. A third of the sea turned into blood. A third of the living creatures in the sea died. A third of the ships were destroyed. Sabi niya, so imagine niyo yung earth, which is mostly a body of water kapag ka nandoon kami sa labas. Now, hatiin nyo yan into three. One third of that destroyed. Now, yan ang dinidescribe ni John dito. Can you imagine that? Yung isang kilo na bigas na hawak-hawak mo, kapag naalog ka pa niya, natapon pa sa lupa. Ang konti na lang inuuwi mo, tapos babagsakan ka pa ng ganyan malaking comet, oh yan. Lalo nang kumunti yung, inuuwi mo. Kapag bigay mo sa misis mo yung isang kilo, eh, two-thirds na lang siya. Sabi ng misis mo, bakit two-thirds na lang ito? May iba ka pang misis, ano? May iba ka pang inahatian. Hindi. This is what John was describing. A third of the living creatures in the sea died. A third of the ships were destroyed. Okay, so there will be a devastation of ocean life and sea life, including sea-going vessels. Now, the third angel sounded his trumpet. And remember, these are events that are going to happen. It does not necessarily mean one after the other, yung bang 1 minute. It can happen a few days or
years
or a month. Hindi naman years, kasi the entire sequence of events will last just about 3.5 years. Kaya, they will generally happen sequentially, but hindi naman yung bang sunod-sunod pagkatapos, hindi. This will consist of a few days timing. Makikita natin yan in a little while. The third angel sounded his trumpet, and a great star, blazing like a torch, fell from the sky. Ito na naman yan. Parang nakikita niya dyan sunod-sunod na mga nagbabagsakan sa ano, sa earth. But this is the sixth seal. This is the beginning of the wrath of God. This is not directed towards you. It is directed towards the rest of the people of this world. Okay, sabi niya, fell from the sky, a third of the rivers and on the springs of water. The name of the star is Wormwood. A third of the waters turned bitter. Many people died from the waters that had become bitter. So, yung sinasabi dito is yung water supply. Yung tubig na iniinom natin. One third of that is going to be destroyed. Yan yung third trumpet. The devastation of the rivers and fresh water life. Yung source natin ng tubig. It will not become usable anymore. Then verse 12. The fourth angel sounded his trumpet, and a third of the sun was struck, a third of the moon, and a third of the stars, so that a third of them turned dark. a third of the day was without light, and also a third of the night. In other words, we are going to have longer nights because of this event. Yan yung fourth trumpet. There will be darkness, one third. The fifth angel, Revelation chapter 9 na tayo, lumipat na siya sa kabilang chapter. The fifth angel sounded his trumpet, and I saw a star that had fallen from the sky to the earth. The star was given the key to the shaft of the abyss. When he opened the abyss, smoke arose from it like the smoke from a gigantic furnace. The sun and the sky were darkened by the smoke from the abyss. Out of the smoke, locusts came down on the earth and were given power like that of scorpions of the earth. In other words, yung mayayari dito is that whatever is represented by these locusts, they have what is called a poisonous sting. And it will spread. Sabi niya, they were told not to harm the grass of the earth or any plant or tree. Okay, now this one becomes very specific. Tingnan niyo mabuti ito. Hindi nila maapektuhan yung natural resources. But only those people who did not have the seal of God on their foreheads. In other words, mayroon lang specific target itong fifth trumpet na ito. Ang tatamaan lang ay yung walang mga seal of God in their foreheads. They were not allowed to kill them, but only to torture them for 5 months. Okay, so matagal-tagal itong part na ito. Ang epekto nitong locust na ito, apparently, is they will torment people for 5 months. Okay, matagal yan, ha? 5 months. During those days, people will seek death, but will not find it. In other words, pag tinamaan ka yan, dahil wala kang marka sa forehead, the seal of God, you will actually want to die. The pain, the agony, the torture, the torment, will make you want to die. But for 5 months, you are not going to die. Can you imagine that? Yung pain, yung sakit, kung gusto mo nang mamatay, nalala ko yan, nabasin ako. Pero this one is different. Nabasin ako. Nung nakita ko yung bagong utras, nakabungo na ako. Okay. But this one is different. It will continue for 5 months. People will want to die. They will actually seek to die. Pero parang yung pagkamalas-malas na tao na nagbigti, pero naputol yung lubid. Kaya uminom siya ng lason, pero dahil nahulog siya, nailuwa niya ulit yung lason. Lahat na klaseng pamamaraan ang gusto mong mamatay, gagawin mo na, but you are not going to die. Okay. Ito yan. During those days, people will seek death but will not find it. They will long to die, but death will elude them. Okay. Yun bang ikaw na mismo, sinusubo mo na yung sarili mong sa kamatayan? But you are not going to die. God will make sure that you are not going to die. Because His intent. It is not that God wants to torment you. Remember that this is a prophecy. The intent of God always, when bad things happen to people, is that so that they will run to God for saving. God does not want people to die because so that when they see that their suffering is coming from God, they will want to seek God's help. But the problem here is people still do not run to God, even when they are already in a bad situation. The locusts, verse 7, look like horses prepared for battles. On their heads they wore something like crowns of gold, and their faces resembled human faces. Their hair was like women's hair, their teeth were like lion's teeth. Now, this is symbolic. It is symbolic because si John was describing a kind of a military weapon or tool that in his time, it does not exist. So ang pinakamalapit na ma-describe niya ay yung kamukha ng mga nakikita niya sa paligid niya. So sabi niya, parang locust, parang kung ano man siya. Sabi niya, meron silang corona na hindi ko malaman kung ano. But they have stings on their tails. Yung bumubuga ng apoy yung ano, yung masamang tao, kind of like that. It's like tanks and helicopters. Lukos kasi lumilipad eh. Okay. So it's more like parang mga aeroplano or helicopters o ano, which does not exist in this time. Pero ang pinakamalapit na kamukha ay parang mga lukos. Sabi niya, ang dami. Okay. Yan yan. They have breastplates, sabi niya, right? Like breastplates of iron. In other words, hindi naman hayop kasi bakal eh. Sabi niya, the sound of their wings was like the thundering of many horses and chariots rushing into battle. Yung tulog po, dumadagundong, sabi niya, parang lumaragas ang mga kabayo. They had tails with stingers like scorpions, and in their tails, they had the power to torment people for 5 months. Okay, apparently this is a chemical or kung ano man gas iyan that is going to attack people, but it will zero in on people who do not have the seal of God in their foreheads. In other words, during this particular time, kahit nasaan kayo, because you have the mark of God, you will be protected. Yung mga nasa side ninyo, tinatamaan ng poison, pero kayo hindi. God is going to make a distinction between His people and the people of this world na tatamaan ito, plagues na ito. As it is also described as the first war. And you will find they are not very different during the days of Moses and the Israelites when they were in Egypt. Merong specific area na kung saan every people are safe. Nagmeron ng plague sa buong Egypt, but the people of God in one area, they are safe. And during this particular period of time, apparently ganyan din ulit ang mangyayari. People around you will be experiencing extreme pain and torment. Pero kayo, hindi kayo maapektuhan. As long as hindi niyo tinurong yung Jesus ninyo, you are not one of the betrayers. Okay? Because if you betray your wife, if you betray your husband at that time, God will also be angry with you. Aabutan kayo nito. Ganun din kayo mga bata. Tandaan ninyo yan. They had as king, verse 11, over them, the angel of the abyss, whose name in Hebrew is Abaddon, and in Greek is Apollyon. Sa English, destroyer. The first woe is past, two other woes are yet to come. Yung sinasabi, first woe, that is the fifth trumpet. Okay. Na nakapaloob naman sa seven seal. Okay naman, nakikita natin yung sequence niyan. Okay, so the fifth trumpet will be human affliction. It will go for 5 months. Okay, the sixth angel sounded his trumpet. So papasok na ito doon sa 6 months na ito. I heard a voice coming from the four horns of the golden altar that is before God. It said to the sixth angel who had the trumpet, release the four angels who are bound at the great river Euphrates. Okay, so this is not an ordinary event. Pagkatapos ng 5 months of torment na iyan, when the sixth angel sounded, the command is, merong mga angels na nakakadena doon sa river Euphrates, pakawalan. The four angels who had been kept ready for this very hour, and day, and month, and year. Okay, so yung timing na kung saan itong angels na ito, they were being given instructions. Matagal na silang naghihintay. 1 year, 1 month, 1 day, and 1 hour. Their job is to kill 1/3 of mankind. These are angels of death. Ito yung mga dinidescribe. Yung kamatayan. ito yung angels na ang imagination natin ay nakatalukbong ng block, tapos merong sight, ganyan. Yan. Pero hindi ito yan, because angels are described differently in scriptures. These are angels who are sword wielding. Hindi yung laser sword ni Darth Vader at sa kanya mo, ni Luke Skywalker. This is different. This is a real sword. This is not a spiritual sword. This is a real sword. It will kill. Kapag tinamaan kayo nito, you are going to die. This is not a unique event. During the days of Israel, there was another death angel na pinupuntahan yung mga bahay-bahay ng Egyptians or any bahay na walang blood on the door post. Papasok yan at tatargetin yung panganay, firstborn ng bawat bahay na walang marka ng dugo. But these angels, they are different. Walang recognition ng panganay o pangalawa o pangatlo. Kasi nung, during the days of Egypt, yung secondborn, thirdborn, they are saying, okay, only the firstborn will die. But this one is different. These angels, four of them, will be released, one-third of all mankind will die. Of course, ito yung mga walang sign of God in their foreheads. See? Pag ipapaptize na yung ngayon, safe kayo. Okay. You are in danger during the Great Tribulation, but if you survive that, you are safe all throughout this period. Okay. The number of the mounted troops was twice 10,000 times 10,000. Twice 10,000 times 10,000. Magkano? Ilan yung 10,000 times 10,000? Maraming million. So, dalawa niyan, 200 million. In other words, these four angels will have a following of 200,000 soldiers killing people left and right. Okay. The number of the mounted troops was twice 10,000 times 10,000. I heard their number. Narinig kasi si John, nandiyan siya sa tabi, meron 24 elders along the throne. Yung one of the elders, nagkukwento sa kanya kung ano nangyayari sa bawat event. The horses, verse 17, and riders I saw in my vision looked like this. Their breastplates were fiery red, dark blue, and yellow as sulfur. The heads of the horses resembled the heads of lions, and out of their mouths came fire and smoke and sulfur. Sabi niya, sa mga bibig, itong mga nakikita ko itong parang mga bakal na yung kumalaman kung ano, buga ng mga apoy at sulfur at kung ano, parang mga canyon ito, parang mga tanks ito. Romaragasa. Kunyas, a third of mankind was killed by the three plagues of fire and smoke and sulfur that came out of their mouths. The power of the horses was in their mouths and in their tails, for their tails were like snakes having heads with which they inflict injury. Ayan. Kasi pagbigyan na lang natin si John dahil ang pamamaraan niya ay mga animals. Pero because that's as close as he can describe yung mga weaponry natin ngayon, which we can actually understand what he is talking about kapag nakita natin ngayon. Pero sa panahon nila, he can only describe them as animals. Yan yung six trumpet, yan yung military destruction. Okay, let's continue. Pagdating ng seventh trumpet, yung seventh trumpet, binubuo naman siya ng tinatawag na seven bowls of plagues. In other words, there is this angel, the seventh angel, pero behind him are a series of seven angels more na may hawak na mga ano yan sa Tagalog? Mangkok. Okay. And inside the mangkok is what is described as plagues. Okay, let's go through that. 11:47. Okay, na tayong tanya. Hopefully. The first plague is described in Revelation chapter 16 verse 2. This is now the seventh angel. When he sounded, meron namang seven angels more na may hawak ng bawat isa na bowls. The first angel went and poured out his bowl on the land. Okay. Remember that this is all a drama in heaven. Merong angel, tumulog na yung seventh trumpet, siya, nakikita niya dyan, binuhos niya yung kanyang bowl doon sa earth.
Okay, at ito nangyari. The first angel went and poured out his bowl on the land, and ugly festering sores broke out on the people who had the mark of the beast and worshipped its image.
Now, remember,
itong mga bowls of plagues na ito, mayroon pa din specific target. Hindi rin kayo kasama. Ang objective nito, ang target nito, ang tatamaan nito, are those who have the mark of the beast and those who worship the image of the beast.
Okay, so this is not for you. But this is for people na maaaring katabi ninyo sa jeep, sa aeroplano, or sa bus. Na kapag kinuwentuhan ninyo yan, hey, alam mo, kapag hindi ka ng bago, tatamaan ka ng bawal ng plane. Labos ka nang tatanda ka nyan. Selfie tayo pare. O yan, itong mukha na ito, itong kaon na ito, nagsara sa akin. Kamapin ninyo ito. Magagalit sa inyo yan. Pero ito ang sinasabi dyan. The first bowl of plague, sabi dyan, is painful sores. In other translations, it is described as boils, meaning pigsa. Yung isang pigsa na masakit-sakit na. Can you imagine kung nabuhusan ka yan all over the body and tinamaan ko yung pigsa? Yung isang pigsa na namunumitin ako sa sakit. Can you imagine kung buwan-buwan meron kong pigsa? Katatapos mo lang matorment ng poison na hindi ka mamatay-matay for 5 months. Eto naman, tutubuan ka ng pigsa.
Okay, well, hindi lahat makaka-relate. Only yung mga tinubuan ng pigsa. Ako, ilang pigsa na tinubuan sa akin.
Kaya alam ko yan, sakit nga.
Pero kung hindi ka makaupo ng maayos kapag dito pa talaga tinubuan, ang hirap matulog sa gabi.
In fact, hindi ka nakakatulog sa gabi. Meron kang excuse para manood ng k-drama.
Okay, yan yung first plague. The second angel, verse 3, poured out his bowl on the sea.
Okay, the first angel poured out his bowl on the land. The second angel poured out his bowl on the sea.
It turned into blood like that of a dead person, and every living thing in the sea died.
Kanina, one third of the living sea creatures died. Ngayon talaga, na wipe out na. Can you imagine kung ikaw ay nakatira malapit sa dagat, yung source of pagkain mo ay nasa dagat? So, ngayon, mawawalan ka na talaga ng pagkukuhaan ng pagkain dahil sa dagat.
Every living thing in the sea died. The sea becomes blood.
Now, kapag familiar kayo doon sa kwento ni Moses and the Israelites, you will find these are not unique events. They have happened before on a small scale. But this one is on a greater scale. During the days of Moses, Egypt, maliit na part lang yan. Egypt sa baba ng Israel, maliit na area lang. But this one will happen on a global scale. Pero ang objective, ang target, ang tatamaan are only those who have the mark of the beast and those who worship the image of the beast. For as long as you do not have the mark of the beast and you do not bow down before the image of this beast, you are safe. Yan.
The third angel, verse 4, poured out his bowl on the rivers and springs of waters, and they became blood.
Kanina, yung sea life. Ngayon naman, yung source, yung the remaining sources of drinking
water. Then I heard the angel in charge of the waters say, "You are just in these judgments, O Holy One, you who are everywhere."
In other words, itong angel ay nagsabi, tama lang yan sa kanila. Yung mga nangyayari na yan.
Why? For they have shed the blood of your holy people and your prophets. Verse 6.
Because these people are the ones responsible for the death of God's people during the Great Tribulation, God is venting out His anger on them. God is avenging for you. Ito yung final infinity war. And God does not need yung infinity stones for power. God has power and He will do this. Sabi niya,
for they have shed the blood of your holy people and your prophets, and you have given them blood to drink as they deserve.
They they have shed your blood, they will drink blood as payment. And I heard the altar respond, yes, Lord God Almighty, true and just are your judgments. So the third thing, the river becoming blood. So Revelation chapter 16, fourth angel. Remember, itong fourth angel ay nandoon ito sa loob ng seven trumpet. Na yung seven trumpet, merong seven bowls of plagues. Yan. The fourth angel poured out his bowl on the sun. Okay, yung fourth angel, ang binuhusan niya ay yung sun, which is 93 million miles away from us. Yan ang binuhusan niya. At ang epekto niyan ay lalo uminit yung sun. And the sun was allowed to scorch people with fire. They were seared by the intense heat and they cursed the name of God. What is happening here is that these people know that they are being tormented by God, but instead of repentance, instead of their hearts calling out for God's salvation, lalo pa sila galit, nagmura. Who have control over these things. They refuse to repent and glorify them. Can you imagine that? All this time, all these things that are happening, because God wanted them to repent. At any time that they changed their mind, God would have said, okay, sige, hindi ka na kasama. But instead of changing their hearts, lalo pang pinasasama yung pinagagalit ng Diyos. Yet they refuse to repent and glorify Him. Verse 10, Revelation 16. The fifth angel poured out his bowl on the throne of the beast. Okay, this time, yung bowl, binuhos naman doon sa trono ng tinatawag na beast. Its kingdom was plunged into darkness. People gnawed their tongues in agony, dumilim sa buong paligid. Curse the God of heaven because of their pains and their sores. But they refused to repent of what they have done. Still, ganun pa rin ang objective ng Diyos. This darkness should have turned their hearts already. Pero hindi pa din talagang matitigas ang ulo. Can you imagine people like that? Sobrang tigas talaga ng ulo na ayaw talaga magsisi. Imbis na magmakiusap na sa Diyos, baka pwede hindi na ako kasama. Pero instead, ang reaction is galit. They refuse to repent of what they have done. Verse 12. The sixth angel poured out his bowl on the great river Euphrates, and its water was dried up to prepare the way for the kings from the east. Then I saw three impure spirits that looked like frogs. They came out of the mouth of the dragon, that is a representation of Satan, out of the mouth of the beast, and out of the mouth of the false prophet. In other words, this is symbolic na nung bumuhos itong bowl na ito, merong lumabas na spirit in the form of frogs na spirits gumalat galing sa dragon, galing sa beast, at galing sa false prophet. And he are described in verse 14. They are demonic spirits that perform signs, and they go out to the kings of the whole world to gather them for battle on the great day of God Almighty. In other words, this is a spirit of war, of yung rage for battle. Look, I come like a thief. Blessed is the one who stays awake and remains clothed, so as not to go naked and shamefully exposed. Then they gather the kings together to the place that in Hebrew is called Armageddon. Armageddon. Okay. Armageddon does not mean end of the world. Armageddon means a place, lugar na kung saan magkakaroon ng gera. This is a place of gathering. It is called Armageddon in Greek, but the Hebrew is actually called Har-Megiddo, which means it is the valley owned by the family of Megiddo, kasi Megiddo is last name. Last name iyan ng mga Hudyo. na nagmamay-ari ng lupa. At sa lupa na iyan, doon magkakaroon ng final battle. Okay. Para malinaw lang tayo, kasi minsan naririnig mo yung term na apocalypse, Armageddon, akala nila is event. No, it's not an event. It's a place.
Okay.
Then, verse 17. The seventh angel poured out his bowl into the air, and out of the temple came a loud voice from the throne saying, "It is done."
Okay. So, after all those seven seals, at the seventh seal, there is seven trumpets. At the seventh trumpet, there is a series of bowls. At the seventh, the final bowl, ang statement is, "It is done." Ito na yun, tapos na. Then there came flashes of lightning, rumblings, peals of thunder, and a severe earthquake. No earthquake like it has ever occurred since mankind has been on earth. So tremendous was the quake.
Okay, so this is another one-time event, unique in history, na earthquake. Parang yung tribulation na one-time unique in history. Not never before, never again. It is the same here, itong earthquake na ito, sabi niya. Ang intensity nito, ang bigat nito, ang lakas nito. Never before, never again. One time. It has never occurred since mankind has been on earth. So tremendous was the quake. How tremendous? Verse 19, Revelation 16. The great city split into three parts. The cities of the nations collapsed. God remembered Babylon the Great and gave her the cup filled with the wine of the fury of his wrath. Every island fled away and the mountains could not be found.
Nagkawalaan yung mga maliliit na isla. Ano yung nangyayari sa Pilipinas? Ano yung nangyayari niya? Tapos the mountains, sabi niya, yung mga nakikita kong bundok, mawala na, na-level na. O, di ang lakas na earthquake na. Can you imagine? Subukan niya yan minsan. Ano yung mga kayo sa bundok? Tapos dainin niya. But that would not be enough. This one is different. When this earthquake happens, it will level the mountain.
At lahat ng klaseng mga islands, sabi niya, nagkawalaan na. And then in verse 21, from the sky, huge hailstones, each weighing about 100 pounds.
Ano yung nakabigat yung 100 pounds? 50 kilos ba? Parang yung isang kabag ng bigas. 50 kilos.
Sangsapo.
O, ganito, kabigat. Yung mga bato, hindi natin alam kung gano'ng karaking bato yan. Basta ang bigat ng bato ay 50 kilos. O, grabe yun. Ang dami niya, no? Nagbabagsakan na bato na 50 kilos. Eh, yung 50 kilos ng araw, pinagunat ko yan, dalawa pa. Dalawa 50 kilos. Okay. Ano yung dati akong kargador sa bukit ng araw? Tinatakbo-takbo pa namin yan kasi yung bawat sako ng bigas na mahahatid mo sa kabila, dahil sa ano, may bayad yan eh, piso. Ano yung piso noong araw? Makakabili ka na ng coke, may pinapay ka na, may pamasahay ka pa. Kasi ang coke noong araw, 25 lang. Nahuguli yung ano ko, noong edad ko. Noong araw yung coke, 25, ano lang. Pag may baon ka na 50 centimos noong araw, may haban ka. May pambili ka na ng soft drinks, may pambili ka pa ng pinapay. Oo, may supli ka pa. 50 centavos. Pero ito yan, magbabagsakan galing sa langit. Mga bato, sabi niya, hailstones, each weighing 100 pounds or 50 kilos. Fed on people! Yung mga makikita mo, magsaktak mo ka! Isa. Can you imagine that? But only to those who have the mark of the beast, who worship the beast. So kayo, okay lang kayo. Kahit maglakad kayo dyan, sa gitna ng mga nagbabagsakan na yan, because you have the mark of God, hindi kayo tatamaan. Pero hindi kayo maglakad yan, mabangga naman kayo ng mga nagbabagsakan. Okay. But this is what people are looking forward to in the future. God will be so angry that He will drop down stones from heaven. Tig. Isang kilo, isang sakong bigas. Ang lakas. Ang lakas. Asan dyan? Ikaw? Habulin mo.
May seem funny to us, but it is happening in the future. It will not be funny. People will be running for their lives. And people, this is something na nakakalusin. Because even when all these things are happening, instead of people repenting, they continue on cursing God. Sabi niya, they cursed God on account of the plague of hell. Because the plague was so terrible. If only their hearts would repent, they would no longer be cursed by this plague. It would have stopped. But people don't change. People just don't change. That's a little frustrating. When we are reading the book of Revelation, sequentially, something of prophetic significance happens before the seventh trumpet and the seventh bowls of plague. Merong mga events. Ito yung events na mangyayari bago ito. Meron yung sealing na 144,000 at meron yung arrival ng two witnesses. Okay. So pagtitingnan ninyo yung sequence of events, merong seven seals, merong seven trumpets. But before the seven trumpets begins, merong tinatawag na sealing na 144,000 and it will continue on doon sa appearance ng witnesses and then papasok yung seven plagues. Because we are running short of time, we will skip some of that. Pero as I said, kung gusto po ninyo ng kopya nitong presentation na ito, and I would like to review it later on, I would be willing to share it with you. Now, let us look at the events prior to the seven plagues. Ito yung seven bowls. Doon sa Revelations 11 and 12 and 13, ang tawag dyan usually ay mga inset chapters. They are not part of the actual sequence, pero they are part of the events na nangyayari in the inside na pinapaliwanag nung one of the elders kay John. Now, doon sa Revelation 11, there is the appearance of two witnesses. Two witnesses, elsewhere, they are also called two prophets. And then sa Revelation 12, we are told of a war in heaven. Si Satan and his demons, they will try to go again up to heaven and they will try to wage war. Pero si Michael and the rest of the angels will defeat them. And then in Revelation 12, after that Satan was thrown back dito sa earth, he will start coming after you. And this is where the persecution of the church begins. Now, doon sa Revelation 13, we are also told of a rise of the beast and the false prophet. Okay. Sa Revelation 7, there is the sealing of the 144,000. Pero yung 144,000 is specific to the tribes of Israel except for Dan. And then, there is a great multitude na kung saan doon nakapaloob the rest of those who are not of Israelite descent, meaning Gentiles, other nations, preceding the seven trumpet blows. Now, doon sa Revelation 7, let's read through it very quickly, beginning in verse 1. After this, I saw four angels standing at the four corners of the earth. This is not the same group of angels na nakakadena kanina. This is a different group of angels. These angels, they are standing on the four corners of the earth. Of course, hindi naman talaga four corners yan kasi bilog yung earth. Isipin nyo, oh, ito proof na black yung earth. Hindi. Yung meron tayong north, meron tayong south, meron tayong east, at saka west. Okay. Ito yan. Nakapwesto sila dyan. Holding back the four winds of the earth to prevent any wind from blowing on the land or on the sea or on any tree. Then I saw another angel coming up from the east, having the seal of the living God. He called out in a loud voice to the four angels who had been given power to harm the land and the sea. Do not harm the land or the sea or the trees until we put the seal on the foreheads and the servants. Ah, ito pala yung four dead angels. Pero sabi sa kanila, dyan lang muna kayo, steady lang kayo. Hanggang hindi namin na mamarkahan yung mga hindi dapat kasali sa tatamaan ninyo. Okay. Then I heard the number of those who were sealed, 144,000 from all the tribes of Israel. Okay, which means 12,000 from each tribe. Yan na yung nandiyan sa Revelation beginning in verse 5, sabi niya, from the tribe of Judah, 12,000 were sealed. From the tribe of Reuben, 12,000 were sealed. From the tribe of Gad, 12,000. From the tribe of Asher, 12,000. From the tribe of Naphtali, 12,000. From the tribe of Manasseh, 12,000. Okay. Ito yung mga anak ni Israel doon sa dalawa niya misis at sa dalawa nila concubine. From the tribe of Simeon, 12,000. From the tribe of Levi, 12,000. From the tribe of Issachar, 12,000. From the tribe of Zebulun, 12,000. From the tribe of Joseph, 12,000. From the tribe of Benjamin, 12,000. Okay. Dito, yung tinatawag na tribe of Joseph is actually the tribe of Manasseh. Kasi nahati sila. Si Manasseh at saka si Joseph ay magkapatid yan. The other one is Ephraim. Pero, because in God, the favored one or the firstborn, pero hindi naman siya ang firstborn, the favored one is given two parts, a bigger part, times two, ang kanyang minamana. So, si Joseph, which represents Ephraim, at si Manasseh, is given 12,000. Si Levi kasama dito. The one tribe na hindi nyo mababasa dito is the tribe of Dan. Because apparently, Dan is a tribe that is so idolatrous that he is going to have to wait before he is part of the people of God. Okay. Chapter 7, verse 9. After this I looked, and behold, there before me was a great multitude that no one could count, from every nation, tribe, people, and language. Okay, maliban sa Israel, meron pang maraming mga tao na masasama doon sa protection. From every tribe, from every nation, people, and language, standing before the throne and before the Lamb. They were wearing white robes and were holding palm branches in their hands. Yung palm branches represents yung a part of the ceremony in Israel, isa sa mga feast nila where they are waving palms to wait to meet the Lord. So ito yan, naghihintay sila ng pagdating. They are waving palms. But they are also wearing white robes. They cried out in a loud voice, "Salvation belongs to our God who sits on the throne and to the Lamb." All the angels, verse 11, were standing around the throne and around the elders and the four living creatures. They fell down on their faces before the throne and worshiped God, saying, "Amen. Praise and glory and wisdom and thanks and honor and power and strength be to our God forever and ever." Now, kaya ganyan yan, because it is in the form of a song. Apparently, when the angels are doing this, sa kay John, he was hearing them in the form of a song, para silang kumakanta. Then one of the elders asked me, "These in white robes, who are they? Where did they come from?" Kasi nakita ni John galing sa tribu ng Israel yung 144,000. Pero meron pang hindi naman galing sa tribu ng Israel. Saan, sino yan? And I answered, "Sir, you know," sabi sa kanya. And he said, sinagot siya ng elder, "These are they who have come out of the great tribulation." In other words, meron naman talagang, because of the events that happened, they repented, they changed, and God actually set them apart. They have washed their robes and made them white in the blood of the Lamb. Therefore, they are before the throne of God and serve Him day and night in His temple, and He who sits on the throne will shelter them with His presence. Never again will they hunger, never again will they thirst. In other words, these people have already been also transformed into a form na hindi na sila magugutom, hindi na rin sila mauuhaw. The sun will not beat down on them, nor any scorching heat, for the Lamb at the center of the throne will be their shepherd. He will lead them to the springs of living water, and God will wipe away every tear from their eyes. I was given a read, talo na tayo sa chapter 11, I was given a reed like a measuring rod and was told, "Go and measure the temple of God and the altar with his worshippers, but exclude the outer court. Do not measure it, because it has been given to the Gentiles. They will trample on the holy city for 42 months. Now, 42 months is a period of time, generally 3.5 years. And I will appoint my two witnesses, and they will prophesy for 1,260 days, clothed in sackcloth. Now, 1,260 days is also 3.5 years. So during the whole time that these events are going to happen, meron ding dalawang prophets na nag-preach in the name of God. So that people will have a way of knowing why are things happening. They are the two olive trees and the two lampstands, and they stand before the Lord of the earth. If anyone tries to harm them, fire comes from their mouths and devours their enemies. This is how anyone who wants to harm them must die. Hindi ibig sabihin na talagang may literal na lumalabas na ano ha, na apoy. Ibig lamang sabihin, as often as they want, they can ask God to send fire by request from heaven. Katulad ito nung power ni Elijah in the early days when he was on earth. Hindi naman talaga si Elijah yung nagpapaulan ng apoy, but he can request God and God will send fire. They have power to shut up the heavens so that it will not rain during the time they are prophesying. They have power to turn the waters into blood and to strike the earth with every kind of plague as often as they want. In other words, they have the same dispense of power na katulad ni Elijah, katulad ni Moses during the days when Moses was in Egypt. Now, in Revelation 12, there is a description also of a war that's going to happen. Sabi niya, verse 7, war broke out in heaven. Michael and his dragons Michael and his angels fought against the dragon. The dragon and his angels fought back. In other words, si Satan ito, represented by the dragon. But he was not strong enough. Si Satan, he will attempt, but he's not strong enough. They lost their place in heaven. The great dragon was hurled down, that ancient serpent called the devil or Satan, who leads the whole world astray. He was hurled to the earth and his angels with him. So ito yung side of the story. In verse 13, Revelation 12, the dragon saw that he had been hurled to the earth. He pursued the woman who had given birth to the male child. Ito na yung persecution, going after the people of Israel. Yung description dyan, the woman represents nation. Pero this particular nation, siya yung he gave birth to the male child. The male child represents the Lord, na kung saan siya nanggaling, and that is Israel. The woman was given two wings of a great eagle so that she might fly to the place prepared for her in the wilderness. In other words, this woman will be given a way of escape. Kahit na habulin siya ni Satan, she was given a place of escape where she would be taken care for a time, times, and half a time. Now, in biblical language, yung time and times and half a time also represents 3.5 years. So yung trabaho ng two witnesses is 3.5 years. Yung woman, where she will be kept safe, is also 3.5 years. So they come, magkakasabay na timing ito. Out of the serpent's reach. Then from his mouth, the serpent spewed water like a river to overtake the woman and sweep her away with a talent. In other words, the demon influenced people to go after the woman, but God helped the woman by opening its mouth and swallowing the river that the dragon had spewed out of his mouth. In other words, the people who are coming after the woman, they will be stuck. They will be, in symbol, swallowed by the river. Actually, this is a symbolism that is very similar to when the armies of Pharaoh, nung dumaan sila doon sa sea, sa Red Sea, they went after Israel. When Israel passed to the other, biglang nagsara yung dry ground na lunod. Now, something similar is going to happen in the future. But most of these are symbolic. We do not know exactly how God is going to stop these people from going after the woman. During the days of Moses, leading the people out of Egypt, it is a literal sea na nahati, and when the armies of Egypt try to follow, na ano sila, nagugulod sila lahat. And this is something similar. Anyone who goes after you in the future, they will not succeed. Because God is on your side. God is going to protect you. But only for as long as you have the mark of God in your forehead. And at the same time, you do not have the mark of the beast, or you did not bow down to the beast. And then the dragon was enraged at the woman and went off to wage war against the rest of her offspring. Okay. Merong mga nakatakas, pero merong mga naiwan. At yung mga naiwan na yan, ito ang description. Those who keep God's commands and hold fast their testimony about Jesus. In other words, meron pa din mga Kristiyano naiwan. Sila ngayon ang pinagbalingan ng galit. Oo, ng dragon. Revelation 13, let's continue. The dragon stood on the shore of the sea, and I saw a beast coming out of the sea. It had 10 horns, 7 heads, with 10 horns, 10 crowns on its horns, and on each head a blasphemous name. Then the beast I saw resembled a leopard, but had feet like those of a bear, and a mouth like that of a lion. The dragon gave the beast his power and his throne and great authority. Yung description ng animal na ito are the strongest parts of the particular animal. Yung leopard, for example, represents speed, bilis. Yung strength of a bear, yung kanyang feet, lahat ba nung ano ng bear ay feet? Feet lahat yun, no? Kahit na claws yan. Okay, yan yung kanyang pinaka strongest part. And yung mouth like that of a lion. In other words, this is a kind of a conquering nation or army na lahat ng malalakas na part ng isang beast, because God always uses a conquering nation as a beast, and God uses a kind conquering king as a lamb. Okay, kaya makita niyo yung distinction. If it is a conquering country that is against God, it is always described as a beast. But if it is an animal coming from God, a kind, a gentle, a caring, you know, it is always described as a lamb. And that is Jesus Christ. Para makita ninyo yung contrast, Jesus is a kind king, but the beast is not so kind. It is destructive. It's hurtful. It is harmful. It is not for your good. Ito ang description niya. The dragon gave the beast his power and his throne and great authority. One of the heads of the beast seemed to have had a fatal wound, but the fatal wound had been healed. The whole world was filled with wonder and followed the beast. People worshipped the dragon because he had given authority to the beast. And they also worshipped the beast and asked, who is like the beast? Who can wage war against it? In other words, when people see this power, they will actually bow down and respect and honor me, because they think that no one can go against it. But that is not true. Verse 5. The beast was given a mouth to utter proud words and blasphemies, and to exercise his authority for 42 months. Ayan na naman yung 3.5 years. In other words, this beast who will conquer the world will have power for 3.5 years. Same time as the two witnesses, same time as the woman being persecuted. For 3.5 years, he will have power, he will go after the woman, but he will not succeed. And at the same time, two witnesses or two prophets will have powers, and they will work for 3.5 years. Lahat yan sila, they are around the same time na contemporaneous. It opened its mouth to blaspheme God, to slander his name and his dwelling place, and those who live in heaven. Your dwelling place represents Jerusalem. Ganyan palagi ang ano niyan. And those who live in heaven, meaning also God. Verse 7, it was given power to wage war against God's holy people and to conquer them. Sino yan? Yan yung mga naiwan. Kasi mayroong grupo na nakatakas na and protected. Pero merong grupo na naiwan, and they will be persecuted. It was given authority over every tribe, people, language, and nation. All inhabitants of the earth will worship the beast, all whose names have not been written in the Lamb's Book of Life, the Lamb who was slain from the creation of the world. Whoever has ears, let them hear. If anyone is to go into captivity they will go. Okay, remember, ang statement dyan is, you will be tested, but you will not be tested beyond what you are able to handle. So there are people who can handle captivity. They will go into captivity. If anyone is to be killed with a sword, they will be killed. There will be Christians who will be able to stand for their faith and be willing to die. They will stand for their faith and they will die. This calls for patient endurance and faithfulness on the part of God's people. Okay, counting is 3.5 years. After that, you will get your reward, immortality and power. Pero counting is 3.5 years. Yan sabi dyan, endure unto the end and you will be saved. You can either go into captivity, you will become slaves, maybe you will do forced labor. Some of you will die, but some of you might be part of those who will be taken into a safe place and you will be protected. Magdasal-dasal na kayo. Masama tayo doon sa protected. Of course, some of us may not go through this experience. We would be among those, Lord, hanggang kailan? Okay. But either way, make sure that your faith holds. Ito ang sinasabi dito. It calls for your patient endurance and faithfulness. Maghintay kayo, magtiis kayo konti. Then I saw a second beast coming out of the earth. It had two horns like a lamb, but it spoke like a dragon. This is not the same beast na military power. This is the same beast, pero religious power. It will represent someone like Jesus Christ. Kung magsalita siya, parang lovely, parang walang, parang hindi siya harmful, harmless. But it speaks like a lamb. In other words, sinungaling ito. Okay. Because remember, the dragon or the serpent represents lies. He is the father of lies. He will sweet talk you. Ito ang ibig sabihin niyan. It exercised all the authority of the first beast on its behalf. In other words, this is a religious authority or power na kung saan ang power niya ay nanggagaling doon sa first beast. And made the earth and its inhabitants worship the first beast. It will encourage you to bow down before this idol, this beast, but not God, whose fatal wound has been healed. In other words, this is a religious authority that will lead you away from God. Now, remember ang sabi ni Jesus, mayroong false Christ, mayroong false prophets. You have to be wary. It performed great signs, even causing fire to come down from heaven to the earth in full view of the people. In other words, this false prophet or this second beast will also have supernatural powers. But that is not new. Remember yung dalawang priest during the days of Moses. Kapag si Moses sinabi siya yung tungkod niya, nagiging ahas. Sila din, yung mga alipores ni Parao, pag hinagis nila yung tungkod nila, nagiging ahas din somehow. Kaya lang, yung tungkod ni Moses is more powerful. Isa-isang nilalaman yung kanilang mga tungkod na naging ahas. Yan. But this is something that is supernaturally powered. Kaya nga ang description, you beware, dahil baka kayo ay mag-deceive. Yan. Because of the signs, it was given power to perform on behalf of the first beast, it deceived the inhabitants of the earth. People will actually believe, kasi may supernatural power din siya. It ordered them to set up an image in honor of the beast, Yun bang katulad ng mga tao sa panahon natin ngayon, kapag yung bato nag-iisang lumuha o kung ano man, people actually believe it. At magdadala yan mga Panginoon, papayang-payang. See, it will happen again in the future. But this time on a grander scale. It ordered them to set up an image in honor of the beast who was wounded by the sword and yet lived. The second beast was given power to give breath to the image of the first beast so that the image could speak and cause all people, all who refused to worship the image, to be killed. In other words, this religious authority will have power over the lives of people. It also forced all people, great and small, rich and poor, free and slave, to receive a mark on their right hands or on their foreheads. In other words, mayroon ka talagang chance to choose. O ano, puwersahan ba natin ito o you're willing to die for your faith? Nalala yung kwento ko dati, pag kinatatakutan ko, pag pumunta ako ng Mindanao, pag pinakasakay ako ng bus, ay merong aakyat na mga Muslim rebels at biglang magtanong na, sino Kristiyano dyan? Can you imagine me standing up? Ako, Kristiyano. Actually, natatakot. To be honest with you, I will be so careful as to stand up and declare, Kristiyano ako, tapos pan. Can you imagine sumasakay lang ako ng bus ng mga matalas? That is not how I want to die. Not yet, anyway. Okay, pero, this is going to happen in the future. Ano ka? Sabbath keeper ka ba o hindi? Sabbath keeper po. Bah. Ayaw mo mamatay? Okay. Duhod. Bow. Get his mark. Kung yan man ay literal na mark. It also forced all people, great and small, rich and poor, free and slave, to receive a mark on their right hands or on their foreheads, so that they could not buy or sell unless they had the mark, which is the name of the beast or the number of its name. Itong buying and selling na ito, in the old Roman Empire, meron talaga yan. Doon sa plaza, merong nakatayo na rebulto ni Caesar. Anyone who does not pay homage to the idol of Caesar, minamarkahan talaga ng mga tao yan. A person who shows disrespect to Caesar cannot have his goods bought and he cannot buy doon sa market. You are being ostracized, you are being marked. Ay yan, hindi yan nagbibigay ng honor o respeto sa image ni Caesar. Huwag yan bentahan, huwag yan bilhin yung kanyang mga parinda. So for true Christians, it will be very difficult to buy or sell in the future. Ito yan. And apparently in the future, meron ulit ganyan. If you are marked as a person who does not worship the image of the beast, people will not buy from your products. You cannot buy from their products. This calls for wisdom, that the person who has insight calculate the number of the beast, for it is the number of the month. That number is 666. Ang sabi nila noong araw, the name of the person, kapag kinumpit mo daw siya, will result into a number that is 666. Sabi naman ng iba, the title of the person will also amount into 666. Now, hindi natin alam how accurate that is, but yun ang isa sa mga tatandaan ninyo, whether it is the name or whether it is the title, apparently, kapag kinalculate mo siya, 666. The reason for that is simple. Noong araw kasi, among the Romans, hindi naman sila numeric yung figures na katulad natin, 1, 2, 3. Noong araw, ang pangalan ng mga Romans, in Latin in particular, is in numerals, di ba? Yung V is 5, tapos yung L is 50, X is 10, I is 1, yung mga ganyan. So, noong araw, if you have a title or if you have a name, pwede nilang calculate yung pangalan mo because they are also Roman numerals. Okay, now we do not know how much of that will translate into our time. Pero in the early days, yung sinasabi daw nila na Viva il Duce, for example, which is a greeting to the Emperor of Rome, amounts to 666. Sabi nila, yung pangalan daw ng original na si Romulus, which is Latinos, pag kinumpit mo daw, it's also 666. What, which is very likely ganyan ang araw because they are using Roman numerals for names and numbers. Okay. Kung haba pa. Pasensya nyo na ako konti. Dahil talagang mahaba itong binigay sa ating na draft. Let's go to Revelation 11, verse 7. Okay. When they have finished their testimony, talking of the two prophets, the beast that comes up from the abyss will attack them and overpower and kill them. Okay. For the longest part of the 3.5 years, the two prophets will be protected. Pero at the end of that, the protection will be lost. God will allow them to die. Their bodies will lie in the public square of the great city, which figuratively is called Sodom and Egypt, where also their Lord was crucified. In other words, these two witnesses will die. Don't think it's kung saan ipinako at namatay si Jesus. This is your place called Skull or Golgotha. Nasa outskirts ito ng Jerusalem. Kung saan yung dalawang prophets, doon din sila mamatay. For 3.5 days, some from every people, tribe, language, and nation will gaze on their bodies and refuse their burial. In other words, their bodies will just be for public display. 3 days. 3.5 days. Their bodies will be on display. The inhabitants of the earth will gloat over them. They will celebrate by sending each other gifts, because these two prophets have tormented those who live on the earth. You know, the whole earth will be happy. Kasi, these people, they have the power to command fire from heaven. They also have power to stop the rain from falling. And apparently, they will do that for 3.5 years. Can you imagine kung 3.5 years na walang ulan? Then, yung wipe out muna, because this is a time of wiping out of all of those natural resources, tapos wala pang ulan, there is no time for the soil to regenerate. Then they heard a loud voice from heaven saying, "Come up here." And they went up to heaven in a cloud while their enemies looked on. After 3.5 days, these two prophets will resurrect. And yan papasok yung the coming of Christ. Kasi alam naman natin yung timing ng resurrection will also be the time that Jesus Christ is coming. Nandiyan na yan sa Revelation 19. Verse 11, "I saw heaven standing open, and there before me was a white horse, whose rider is called Faithful and True. With justice he judges and wages war." Do you notice yung first horse kanina? Is also white. Meron din siyang corona, pero meron siyang bow. This one is also a rider who is on a white horse. So talagang he is trying to mimic or falsify the representation of Jesus. Nakasakay din siya sa white horse, he is a conqueror, he is, meron siyang corona, meron siyang bow. And Jesus is also the same. He falls Christ. "His eyes are like blazing fire, on his head are many crowns. He has a name written on him that no one knows but he himself. He is dressed in a word dipped in blood, and his name is the Word of God." Now, is that sound familiar? In the beginning was the Word. The Word was with God, and the Word was God. Yung parang sas ito eh, parang Miss Universe, praying ito Miss Universe, ang talagay ay Word of God. Ganun ang pag-isipan niya. "He is dressed in a robe dipped in blood. His name is the Word of God. The armies of heaven were following him," meaning the angels, "riding on white horses." Ah, dami na. Akala nyo ba ang kabayo, physical lang? Hindi, sila din. Meron din sila mga spiritual horses na sinasakyan. "Dressed in fine linen, white and clean. Coming out of his mouth is a sharp sword with which to strike down the nations." Okay, symbolic naman ito. Hindi ito ibig sabihin na sa bibig ni Jesus may lumalabas na sure. Na sword. Okay, hindi ganyan. This is represented by a word that comes out of his mouth that is as sharp as a sword. "He will rule them with an iron scepter. He treads the winepress of the fury of the wrath of God Almighty. On his robe and on his thigh, he has this name written, King of Kings and Lord of Lords." In other words, doon sa robe, meron nakasulat, King of Kings and Lord of Lords. Sa robe at saka sa tayo sa kanyang armor, body armor. Okay. Pangalawa is yung tinatawag na Armageddon. Yung sa Revelation 16, verse 16, kanina binasa natin, they gathered them together to the place called in Hebrew, Armageddon. And as I mentioned, Armageddon is not an event. Armageddon is a place of battle. Dito magtatagpo yung armies ng beast at yung armies coming from heaven. And let's go to Revelation 19, kung saan makikita natin ito. Revelation 19, beginning in verse 17. I saw an angel standing in the sun, who cried in a loud voice to all the birds flying in mid-air, come gather together for the great supper of God. Okay, now as again, as I mentioned, ito is from the vantage point of John. Hindi ito literally na yung angel, nakatayo all the way doon sa sun. Pero from John's vantage point, parang nakatayo si angel doon sa ibabaw ng sun. Maliit lang naman yung sun, nakatayo yung angel doon. From the perspective natin, nakatingin. Kasi paano na naman maririnig yung angel all the way, 93 million miles yung nandudulog siya. Ang kausap niya, mga evil na nandito. Hindi ganyan yan. The symbolism is that from the vantage point of John, the angel was like standing on the sun. Ito yung earth, ito yung sun, kung sunset man yan, kung saan man yan, the angel was like standing on top. Pero within speaking distance to the bird. Sabi niya, okay, kayong mga ibon, mag-abang kayo dito, marami kayong kakainin. So that you may eat the flesh of kings, generals, and the mighty, of horses and their riders, and the flesh of all people, free and slave, and great and small. This is going to be a bloodbath. Ang daming mamamatay dito. The armies of the beast, as against the armies of God. Pero siyempre, paano naman papatayin yung spirit being? Hindi naman mamamatay yan. So they will die. And the birds will feast on their bodies. I saw the beast and the kings of the earth and their armies gathered together to wage war against the rider of the horse and his army. That's Jesus and the angels. But the beast was captured, and with it the false prophet who had performed the signs on its behalf. Oh, see, naging malinaw na ngayon. Kanina dinidescribe siya as a second beast. Pero this time, siya pala yung false prophet who had performed signs on its behalf. With these signs he had deluded those who had received the mark of the beast and worshipped its image. The two of them were thrown alive into the fiery lake of burning sulfur. So yung beast at saka yung false prophet itinapon doon sa dagat-dagatang apoy na wala pa ngayon. Ito pa, sa future pa. Na huwag kayong matakot. Wala pang tinatapon doon. It's not yet there. But in the future, it will be. Magiging takunan talaga siya ng mga katawan. Verse 21, the rest were killed with the sword coming out of the mouth of the rider on the horse. All the birds gored themselves on their flesh. And pangatlong event is the resurrection of the saints. Nandiyan yan sa Revelation 20. I saw an angel coming down out of heaven, having the key to the abyss, and holding in his hand a great chain. He seized the dragon, that ancient serpent, who is the devil or Satan, and bound him for 1,000 years. So yung dalawang humans, yung beast, at saka yung false prophet, they will be thrown into the lake of fire. But Satan's fate is different. Siya naman, ikukulong lamang siya for the next 1,000 years. He threw him into the abyss and locked and sealed it over him, to keep him from deceiving the nations anymore until the 1,000 years were ended. After that, he must be set free for a short time. In other words, this demon, Satan, the serpent, the dragon, ikukulong siya for 1,000 years. Pero pakakawalan din siya doon sa dulo for a short time. And I saw thrones on which were seated those who had been given authority to judge. And I saw the souls of those who had been beheaded because of their testimony about Jesus and because of the word of God. Okay, resurrection. Yung mga yung mga natanggalan ng ulo, kasama na si Paul dyan, natanggalan ng ulo, they were resurrected. They had not worshipped the beast or its image and had not received its mark on their foreheads or their hands. They came to life and reigned with Christ for 1,000 years. Kasama na dyan yung dalawang prophets kanina na namatay. This is the time of their resurrection. And then we are told, the rest of the dead did not come to life until the 1,000 years were ended. And this is the first resurrection. Where, kayo, kung nasama kayo doon sa mga namatay, mamumuhay kayo ulit. And you will reign with Christ for 1,000 years. But those who had become unfaithful, who had become betrayers, they will remain dead. Now, yan ang sinasabi sa atin. So, nasaan na tayo? In prophecy. Okay, nasaan na tayo? Where are we now in prophecy? Diniscuss natin yung seven seals. Diniscuss natin yung sealing ng 144,000. And then there is the seven trumpets. And then there is the persecution, seven plagues. And then there will be the two witnesses. And then there is the return of Jesus Christ. Nasaan tayo dyan sa timeline na yan? Definitely, wala pa tayo doon sa period ng trumpets. Otherwise, makikita natin dyan, babagsakan yung heavenly bodies. So, nasaan tayo? We are in the period that is called the seals. Now, the four horsemen apparently had been running for quite some time. Since the time of the apostles. Kasi yan ang timeline nila. Tumatakbo na yan sila. And we would be living somewhere close to the fifth seal and coming towards the sixth seal. Now, bakit? Kasi yung fifth seal, remember, they are composed of saints who are already dead calling for vengeance. But there is an event ahead of us where there will be a mass murder of all the saints. Now, meron nang nagdadasal dyan na hanggang kailan? Maghintay kayo hanggang hindi pa namamatay yung inyong brothers and sisters. So we are, para sabihin natin, in the middle of the fifth seal, meron ng mga namatay, pero meron pang mga marami dito sa bandang dulo bago pumasok yung sixth seal. Today, we are in that time period. We are living somewhere close to that, the fifth seal, and we are coming towards the sixth seal. Yan yung pinaka-conservative view. Alam natin na wala pa tayo sa sixth seal kasi wala pa mga supernatural signs na nagbabagsakan. Alam din natin na wala pa yung sealing ng 44,000 at saka yung innumerable multitude. Those are events that must happen first. Alam din natin na wala pa tayo doon sa two witnesses because hindi pa natin sila nakikita. So we are coming to that timeline. So just as a quick review, yung first seal, yung false Christ, yung second seal, wars and rumors of wars, yung third seal, which is famine, and yung fourth seal, this is epidemics, nandi dyan lahat dyan. But, as we come close to the end, they will become even intensified. Palakas iyan ang palakas. Habang paparating sa dulo yung mga riders ng horses, yung epekto sa likod nila will become intensified as well. And then, papasok tayo doon sa tribulation and persecution. But remember that yung primary cause ng tribulation and persecution natin is the beast power, which sa ngayon ay wala pa. So, for as long as wala siya, hindi pa tayo pumapasok doon sa tinatawag talaga na never before, never again, great tribulation. And of course, kapag pumasok na iyan, alam natin na papasok na din yung heavenly signs. Okay. So the first six seals, they have occurred over a long period of time. And God has His reasons for that. Ang sabi ni Peter, kaya mahaba iyan because we are being given a time to repent. It is so that we can be saved. The end time signs are a warning. Kapag nakikita na natin yung mga maliliit na signs na sinabi ni Jesus, it is warning us, hoy, ayusin nyo na yung mga buhay-buhay ninyo. Because the signs are coming. The dreadful day of the Lord is coming to a close. Sabi nga ni Peter, balikan natin yan. 2 Peter chapter 3, verse 8 to 9. Sabi ni Peter, do not forget this one thing, dear friends. With the Lord, a day is like a thousand years, and a thousand years are like a day. From the days of Jesus Christ up to today, it has been around 2,000 years. But, sabi nga ni Peter, para sa Diyos, dalawang araw pa lang ang nakalipas. Sa atin ang tagal na. Pero para sa Diyos, makita lang naman doon, dalawang araw pa lang. Okay. At huwag kang magmadali, bakit ready ka na ba? And that is the next question. Can you imagine if the Lord really comes today? Are you ready? Can you really say that you are ready today? Ako ngayon na. I don't know about you. Maybe you are. Good for you. See? But yan ang tanong. But because God wanted to save everyone, because He actually loves you, He really does not want you to perish, He will give you sufficient time. At katulad nga nung sabi ko, ako at my age, every day I wake up in the morning, nagpapasalamat na ako. Because I still have a chance to make things right. Every day that I wake up in the morning, it is a fresh chance for me to make things right. A chance for me to enter the kingdom of God. We also believe that once the seventh seal is opened, the first trumpet is blown, then all the events will come in rapid succession. Ang tinitingnan natin dyan is about 3.5 years. That's a very short time. Short time already. The length of the seven trumpets will run is still unknown to us. Kung kailan talaga siya mag-uumpisa. Yan kasi yung period na sinasabing it will come like a thief. Now, meron na tayong progression ng in the last days. Pero, kung kailan talaga mag-uumpisa yung the day of the Lord, wala pa tayong idea niyan. For as long as certain events do not yet fall into place, we still have time to make corrections and changes in our life. The abomination of desolation, for example, spoken of by Daniel, diyan mag-uumpisa yan sa seventh trumpet. Wala pa yan ngayon. It will be triggered by the rise of the last beast na sinasabi dito. But it is still a time of repentance for mankind. Revelation 11 verse 6. These two witnesses, they have the power to shut up the heavens so that it will not rain during the time they are prophesying. In other words, isa sa mga malinaw na timeline natin, na makikita natin, is the rise of the two prophets. For as long as we do not see them, meron pa tayong time. Meron pa tayong time. They have power to turn the waters into blood, to strike the earth with every kind of plague as often as they want. Now, maaaring nandi dyan na yung two prophets na yan, maaaring wala pa. Because I'm sure, hindi naman mga 10-year-old ang mga yan. If the time that they begin their work, they would be in their 30s or in their 40s. Si Moses, when he began to be called by God to bring the people out of Egypt, 80 years old na siya. So hindi natin alam, maaaring pinanganak na itong dalawang prophet na ito, maaaring hindi pa. 30 years from now, they will be 30 years old. 80 years from now, ay hindi pa sila pinanganak. 1 year old pa lang sila ngayon, if they start the job at 80. But what we do know is that the moment we see these two witnesses, you are looking at 3.5 years. But a lot of things still has to happen. Okay, let's summarize. Now we have read from the pages of our Bible the blow-by-blow account of yung tinatawag na the last days. And yung day of the Lord itself, which is the trumpets, as revealed by Jesus Christ. Like John, you have been to the future and back. Para nakita na natin yung mangyayari in the future. And we are now back to our time. You had the opportunity to see the future in vision. There is no need for us to speculate or guesswork or personally interpret and understand yung mga end time events. Nandiyan yan sa book of Revelation. Jesus plainly revealed them to John, and now we have shared it with you. You saw it as all as they were unfolded before you. Now Jesus said, blessed is anyone who reads the words of the prophecy And blessed are those who take it to heart. In other words, kung ano man yung mga napakinggan ninyo at naunawaan ninyo, keep them in your heart. They will be a blessing to you in the future. Kapag nag-umpisa nang mangyari yan, then you will know that God is beginning to start the return of His Son, the events that will assure the return of His Son. And finally, we have this assurance, the words of prophecy in Revelation 22. Ano sabi sa atin? Verse 6, the angel, sabi kay John, these words are trustworthy and true. Sabi niya, mapagkakatiwalaan mo ito, totoo ito. The Lord, the God who inspires the prophets, sent His angels to show His servants the things that must soon take place. Look, I am coming soon. Because this is Jesus talking, sabi niya. Blessed is the one who keeps the words of this of the prophecy written in this scroll. In other words, take it to your heart. Bantayan ninyo iyan. Verse 10, then He told me, do not seal up the words of the prophecy of this scroll, because the time is near. In other words, hindi ito yung katulad ng sinabi ng angel kay Daniel, na seal the words of this prophecy, it is not for you. By the time Jesus came on the scene, sabi niya, hindi na, keep it open. People need to understand. Do not seal up the words of the prophecy of this scroll, because the time is near. Let the one who does wrong continue to do wrong. Now, the moment these events begin to happen, meron ng warning si Jesus Christ. This is a time where any change you do is not going to be of any help. Meron din namang deadline. Ang Diyos meron deadline. Binibigyan niya tayo ng chance for as long as He can. But there is a marker that says, ito na yan. If you are a person who does wrong, sige, tuloy mo na lang. Sabi niya, if you are a person who is vile, sige na, tuloy mo na yan. Because whatever you do, it will not change the outcome anymore. But, sabi niya, if you are a person who does right, continue to do right. And if you are a person who is holy, continue to be holy. Now, bakit yung masama ang sabi eh, sige na tuloy mo yan. Pero bakit yung mabuti, sige tuloy mo yan. Because there is a scripture in Ezekiel chapter 18, harapin nyo na lang yan, basahin nyo yan, that says, if you are a good person and you went bad, all the good things that you do, God will not make it count. It is for one bad thing that you do that you will die. That is why this is the warning in Revelation. When these events begin to happen, when the deadline has reached its time, if you are a bad person, sige na ko yun yan, kahit anong pagbabago mo, wala nang pag-asa ikaw. But if you are a good person, make sure na ituloy mo yung pagiging good. Because if you turn, all the good things that you do will not be counted. You will die for the one bad thing that you do. Sounds familiar? Di ba ganyan ang sinasabi natin? Bakit pag ang ginagawa ko mabuti, walang nakakaalala? Bakit pag gumawa ako ng masama? Yun na lang ang nakikita ng tao. But do not be mistaken. God is also the same. All the good things that you do, sabi niya, I will not remember it if you do evil. Kaya, if you are good, ituloy mo yan. If you are a person who does right, make sure you continue. If you are a person who keeps yourself holy, make sure that you remain holy. Look, I am coming soon, verse 12. My reward is with me, and I will give to each person according to what they have done. I am the Alpha and the Omega, the first and the last, the beginning and the end. Then the warning from God, who foreknew that this book and His revelation will be mangled by many. Ito yan, Revelation 22. I warn everyone who hears the words of the prophecy of this scroll. If anyone adds anything to them, God will add to that person the plagues described in this scroll. In other words, kapag ikaw tinamaan ng 10 pipsa, at pinakialaman mo pa yung Revelation, 15, dagdagan pa natin ng 5 ang pigsa na tatama sa iyo. The torment, the pain will add up. Dagdagan yan. God will add to that person the plagues described in this scroll. If anyone takes words away from the scroll of this prophecy, yung ikaw yung nagdagdag. Yung isa naman nagbawas. Para kumilik natin naman nagdagdag, nagbawas. Okay. May penalty. If anyone takes words away from this scroll of prophecy, God will take away from that person any share in the tree of life and in the holy city, which are described in this scroll. In other words, you will lose your chance at immortality. Because if you take away from the scroll of the prophecy, you are denying people salvation. And God is saying, if you are denying people an understanding of salvation, you will be denied yourself. You will not enter. Yan ang warning niya. And then, he who testifies to these things says, yes, I am coming soon. That's Jesus. Amen. Sabi ni John, come, Lord Jesus. The grace of the Lord Jesus be with God's people. Amen. So please, take this prophecy to heart. And this presentation may conflict with your long-held belief. But the key is not to believe anyone or yourself. The key is to believe what is written in the Bible. And may you all be blessed with this knowledge. Thank you for coming. Thank you for your patience. And we would like to invite you again next month for another round of Bible study. Oh, by the way, meron tayong mga literature dito na related to the topics we have discussed. Kung huhala po kayo ng kopya dyan sa likod, meron tayong What is the Mark of the Beast? Meron tayong Is Armageddon Just Ahead? Meron tayong The Church that Jesus Built? At meron tayong Immortality, God's Gift to the Saints. Huwag po kayo mag-alala, libre po iyan, hindi po namin kayo hahabulin kapag kayo ay kumuha. Kung meron kayong mga kaibigan na gusto niyong bigyan na wala rito, magdala po kayo ng extra kopya. So once again, thank you for coming. Thank you for your patience. And hope to see you again next month for another Bible study.